Hello, 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 Noble, flipping the table and dropping the scaredy cat. A wizard shouldn't use a timer, what? I'm not a wizard, you can't prove anything. Quasi is late. Quasi, shame on you, damn it, Stixie. Calling me out, Gainesville BR, what's up, dude? Zoot, Haystein, Noble, Vandy, Elmer Fuddied, Slug Boot, the bootest of all the slugs. Stixie, how's it going? Monty Blanks, what? Monty Blanks was here. Don't tell, I'm not here. What? Is he still here? I don't even know. Tropical Banana Man, how's it going? Krasenstein, what's going on, dude? What are the jerks are hanging out in this place? What are the jerks are in here? Game night, how's it going? Wow, Trav was busy before I even got here. What's going on, guys? Did I miss anyone? Did I miss somebody? Penguin, how's it going? Victor HSB, how's it going, dude? GG, GG indeed. I ruined my evening. I'm glad I did. Quasi, he lives. If streamer equals like banana suit equals true. Damn it, Vandy. Well, let me close the window. There's a lot of car noise coming from outside. All right. Let's get ready to do the Smith. How's it going, dude? Let's do it. Ah! First time in a long time I've been here for the start. It's good to have you here. Quasi, you have to explain to me, why did you remove QuasiFax? I didn't remove QuasiFax. I simply don't have our old bot. Wow, I'm super green outline today. Super spooky outline. I don't have Ankhbot back. I keep forgetting to bring Ankhbot back. Somebody was supposed to remind me last time, but you guys failed this city. So we'll have, I have Ankhbot. I have a backup that I need to come transfer over to a new computer, and I keep forgetting to do it. So I need someone to remind me off stream on Discord or something. So I remember to do that. Can we fix this green outline, you guys think? Probably not. Is it because my chroma key needs to be more similar? There we go, that's better. That's better. No more green outline. Stop the Moobot overlords. Dang nabbits, like, yeah, the arrow command is also gone. Turn off the autofocus because that drives me crazy. Nothing to focus on, it's just my face. All right. It's unfixable. Let's get right into the news. But Bob the Badger can fix it. What are you talking about, Game Nighted? You're watching Arrow Season 4. Is that the newest one, or are we on Season 5? I have failed this city. I'm sorry, Einstein. I'm sorry. Noble! 4 months! Can we get some hype and hearts in chat? 4 months in a row!
Guys and lads, you need to sub. The Discord is full of love and awesome. Join the Trick Squad.
Noble, thank you so much for the 4 months of support, dude. You are freaking amazing. Can we please get some hearts in chat? For the nopest of all the polls we know. Thank you for that support, dude. And yeah, Discord is awesome. There's so much game dev happening on Discord, which is so freaking cool. People showing, sharing screenshots of their games, getting feedback, and like Devin is working on it. Shanna! 2 months! Oh my goodness! The sub hype is real! That's already two!
Love your stream.
Thank you so, so very much for 2 freaking months of support. Guys, can we please get some hearts and hype in chat for the 2-person sub train? Holy crap. Our sub train thing doesn't work anymore, I realize. I'm pointing at this cup, but I'm pointing through the cup. Through the cup. We used to have like a sub train thing. It's not working anymore. I gotta look into that. Zelda Addicted, how's it going? Can we please get some hype and hearts in chat for these 2 recurring jerks hanging out with the Jerk Squad? I want to sub, but I'm not rich enough. No worries, Ace. Never any pressure to sub. Never, ever any pressure to sub. So guys, we're back to work on Skyhook. We are, if anybody missed the Friday stream, we are taking a little detour. We are working on the Halloween update for Skyhook, as it says in the stream. I can't point up anymore. I got to point down, as it says in the stream title. And last week on Dragon Ball Z, we made these 2 new icons for Versus and Quest. So we got a Versus Pumpkin and a Candy Corn Quest. I hope the sub train is longer. I need to analyze the sub messages for my Twitch chat parsing, Neville. Shanna, thanks for the cheers. Why are you pressuring me to sub? I'm sorry, Einstein. I don't know what else to say. Is a Discord sub only? It is Game Nighted. Yeah, the Discord is currently sub Discord. So we made it so the ship changes. I made a couple of changes to the ship, as you guys might be able to tell. The color's a little bit different. I added a bunch of cracks and stuff, so you can see the bottom of the ship here is all like broken up into pieces, so it looks like, you know, it's more ghostly, I guess. I added more scratches and holes and dents and scratches and stuff like that. I didn't actually work on Skeleton. I worked on a couple of other bugs. Why are you running? Why am I running? This book about Neat is hard. What is Neat? N-E-A-T? Is it like a programming thing? Elmer, thanks for the cheers!
Because IDB is awesome, Quasi love.
Thanks for the love, dude. Thank you very much. Slovenian Devil, how's it going? So I didn't get any chance to work on Skeleton, who is the new skin we're working on as of Friday. You guys can see him right here in box number one. What I did work on is a couple of other really, really urgent bugs that have been bothering me. So Saturday, if you guys don't know, Saturday I volunteered at the Buffalo Game Space and we taught teenagers how to make games. It was a 24-hour jam. So it was from the previous night to the Saturday night where we worked with teenagers to develop a small game, their first ever game in a game jam. And it was pretty awesome. So that was my Saturday. And then Sunday was working on some bugs and issues in Skyhook. So like one of the things I worked on is, you guys can't even see it, but this thing over here that says select and cancel had a lot of issues with it. So I was able to fix that. I was able to fix some issues with that ready button and with the team. This thing here had some bugs in it, so I was able to fix that. I also found a bug this morning that you notice how here it's raining. I don't know if you guys, can you guys see it? There's like rain falling. Well, that rain was also falling here. So I made it not show the rain when it's happening here. Carroy, how's it going? Neural evolution of augmented topologies. Sounds serious, Dixie. That sounds serious. I'm doing good, Coward. How are you? And the other thing I fixed slash change, I fixed a bunch of things. A whole bunch of little bug things. And I actually updated the game on Steam too to push those updates finally. Fixed resolution bugs and stuff as well. I was the only one that saw the bottom part of the stream became glitched pink. I should come to your high school to Vandale? That would be cool. That'd be awesome. You should get your high school to fly me out there. I'll totally do it. I'll totally do it. So today we're going to work on Skelephant. Did you showcase Skyhook during the game jam? No. It wasn't a showcase. It was called the Queen City High School Jam. It was the first ever high school jam where they got all the different high schools in Buffalo sent their top students interested in game development to learn from us and make a game with us. So it wasn't a showcase. It was more of a teaching kids thing. I'm doing okay. I'm glad you're doing fine. Thanks, dude. The Xbox controller keeps getting smacked against my tower. I also made the ship purple. The ship used to be red, now it's purple. Doorframe Wizard, what's up, dude? Good to see you. The buffer A9. Did you show it to the students as example of work? Oh, yeah, I did. Yeah, they asked me kind of what stuff I did. I showed them my Twitch channel as well. So I don't know if any of them are hanging out right now in chat. But if they are, they should know that they're amazing. I guess they should be in school. They shouldn't be hanging out in chat right now. Should I rephrase that? Oh, yeah, no worries. What I did also do is design, not this pumpkin. We got to work on the pumpkin. We got to clean up the pumpkin because the candy corn is pretty clean, pretty much there. We got to clean up the pumpkin today before I forget and procrastinate that because I really hate cleaning up pixel art. It's so boring. But I did make these. Check them out. I made these last night. I couldn't sleep. So I foolishly had coffee at like 10 o'clock at night and I had trouble falling asleep, but I need to go to sleep, you know, at a reasonable time. To wake up for today, I ended up getting caught up working on skeleton skins. So this is a skeleton, the one we're working on. I decided to give him an eye, a green eye. All the skeleton skins are green eyes. So this is skeleton, the one we're going to make today, or finish today, hopefully. This is Skella Jade. So she's a skeleton cat. Is it normal that your character in character selection can get out of the frame? It is, yeah. It's actually an achievement. Foolish. Wait, you mean like leaving the box, right? You mean like doing this? Meep. This is actually a secret, but spoiler alert, it's a secret. This is Skella Jade. This is Skellinara, which is probably going to be the easiest one, hopefully, because all we have to do is replace all of her faces and her arms, and then she'll be good to go. The green eyes are cool, right? I think so, too. It's cute, thanks, Zelda. What's my favorite coffee? I don't really have a favorite coffee. I haven't experienced that many kinds of coffee. I'm currently drinking Trader Joe's K-Cups. What up, Quasitown? So much monsters. What's up, dude? Good to see you. This is Skellaruna, so hopefully she's going to be really easy too, because again, we're just replacing her head, her helmet's a little bit different, and we're going to replace her arm in most of her sprites. And then Skella Grimlock is going to be a little challenging, because he actually has a ribcage showing through his body. And Skella Briggs, this is a character that doesn't actually exist in the game, so we don't have to worry about him yet. Should Skella Nar have hair, though? That's a good question. I tried her without hair. Let's give it another shot. So this is how she would look without hair. What's the problem? Oh, this is it. Let's see how she would look without hair. This probably makes more sense. Because then it's just Skull wearing a hood. But something about the shape just seems odd, so maybe it should just like come down a little bit or something. Maybe have the hood just come over the head a little bit more. Yeah, it does look better without hair. Yeah, since she's a skeleton. I do hate it when skeletons have hair, because it's like, that can happen. Right, obviously. Skeleruna. Hell yeah. Maybe add a tear in Inara's pant leg to shirt to increase the spooks. So I did, actually, I think I deleted it. I did do that where you can like kind of see what happens is it becomes hard to tell like what's going on because the sprites are so small. On top of that, it makes it harder for us to animate as well. So, I mean, we could try something like this where we put some tears in here. It might not be super hard to do, but it makes it almost look like there's just stripes or something. I'm not really sure. It's hard to like address that, hey, this is actually a leg ripping through her pants as opposed to just like, I'm not sure if it comes across. What do you guys think? Prefer with hair? Yeah, it does look better with hair, but it is technically unrealistic. That is sorta good. You're sorta good, Haystein. Yeah, I don't know. It's tough. How did you start programming and game development? In my first year of computer science, but want to know what to do when I'm done, MDon. The best thing to do is to make games in your own time. Don't rely, this is what I tell to everyone who's in college, don't rely on doing what, just doing your school projects and that's going to teach you how to make games. Like, that is the worst way to learn how to make video games. You have to be making your own stuff on your own time, because doing your school projects will only take you so far. So you have to be doing your own projects as well. Can't stay long, I came home at 2 a.m. tonight and I'm going to Amsterdam tomorrow at 10 a.m. with your girlfriend. Awesome, Stixy, have a good time, dude. That is awesome. And no worries, get some rest. It's a walking skeleton, are you really worried about realism? I think the tears read very well. Yeah, I totally agree, Neville. There's just not enough room, you know, in her sprite. But it's fine. I mean, these are just Halloween sprites. Like, they don't have to be that big of a deal, I guess. Unless we just take off her pants and just give her skeleton legs, but that's going to make us a lot. Like, skeleton turned out to be a lot more work than I wish she was, but the problem is Finn is naked, right? Finn doesn't have clothes on anyway. Only Monk Dolphin has his clothes on, so we had no choice but to make Finn a completely naked skeleton. Hair's unrealistic. No, skeletons fighting with grappling hooks is unrealistic. Call me out. Gotta go personal thing. No worries, Kyrie. Have a good one. I think video games as school projects. Right. So if you're making video games as school projects, don't let that be the only video games you make that year in school. Like, one of the things I hated the most when I was hiring in my last job is when you would interview someone and be like, so what have you worked on? And I went to the same school that I was hiring from, right? So they'd be like, oh, I made, you know, this complicated platformer with real-time physics and C++, and I made this, you know, dashboard for social media management, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, you mean the projects from 380 and 308 and 305? Like, I took those classes. Those are just school projects. That doesn't show me you've learned anything. Also doesn't show me that you have the drive outside of class. No pants is a symbiote here to hear that. Full screen Chrome. Nice, Ergathian. Now you're going to have to watch the full experience. Until it goes to calling walking skeletons realistic. Yeah. Yeah, I think we'll probably leave her like just like that, just because it'll be easier for us to actually get her sprites done. Same with Runa and with Jade. So Finn is the most involved one. Let's finish him up. Alt tab. No, why are you leaving me, Shanna? Can somebody that's into websites please tell me where it's good to start? Book or something for making a graphic website like onehourgamejam.com. Where's a good start? I don't know, because I don't have any good resources. I used to read a lot of Smashing Magazine, but that's more web design than web front-end development. Potato, what's up? F11! Wait, F11 is full screen, right? Okay. Whew, thought you were leaving me. Thought you were pressing F12. Wait, what's F12? I don't know. I don't want to find out. Okay, anyways, let's get to work. So priorities, we're going to finish Skeleton. It's the guy we started animating last week, and I need to move this guy away from behind my head. So let's move him over here so you guys can see the animation. There we go. So we're all work, and this is so you guys go, whoa, so you guys can see. Alt F4, quick, everyone do that now. No, Smith, please. Alt F dollar sign. F12 is developer mode, right? It is. Code Academy is a good place, yeah. What about Alt F pants? Oh, and so after creating all of the skeleton skins, so we have a problem, right? I designed all these skins that are supposed to be like the white color skins. These are like the snow skins, and they'll be with Hammerfin. And Briggs is brown, so I realized, oh, the skeletons could all be the brown skins. Because right now the white skin already exists for Hammerfin, so we need like a new skin color for the skeleton colors. So these will be brown skins. So I actually need to grab this color here in Unity. So if we go to our skin manager, which is in here. Player creator, skins, Finn, his last one should be Skeleton. So you see he has white, violet, and Skella. So the Skella ones are actually going to be brown. Wait, where do I set their colors? I don't actually remember. Where do the colors come from? The flags? Whoa, I don't remember where the colors come from. Flag, no, not this. Character box? No, that's not it. Game over panel, does it? So whenever we show the player's flags, we call them to the color of that skin. I actually don't know where that skin color is set up. I always thought it was in here. But I must have moved it somewhere to make it better. So let's see, has confirmed, trophy panel, generate trophies, update stats, set profile. Where's the flag? Or icon, flag, no. Trophy panel, victory animator. Ah, not this one. Victory animator. So here is the flag sprite. And okay, so they pass in some team color. Where does all this come from? Why can't I remember? I should have written this down in the wiki probably. So the player has a original skin dot color type. Team color, light flag color, dark flag color, default flag color. So team color comes from red team, blue team, otherwise it comes from their character color. And character color comes from this method, okay. Oh, so it is all defined in code. What? No, it's not. Suspicious. What's up, Katchenek? How's it going? What is the difference between HTML and PHP, which gives you an advantage to make a better looking website? HTML is... I'm probably the best person to explain, to define this properly. But you need both. You need both. How do you make your Yeti sound so good, Harris? I have the gain set to only take audio from forward, and I have a pop filter on it, which helps with like popping sounds. Can you see this? Yeah. So I have the Dragon Pad pop filter on it, which helps with like popping sounds. When I say pop, 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 it sounds better. Not totally back. I'm totally not back judging you, Zoo. Damn it! Can you answer that question? So I use the pop filter, which helps, and I just have the gain set to forward so it doesn't pick up too much sound behind it. That's mostly it. The rest of it's just my beautiful, beautiful voice. Picked up Pixel Edit after watching you work. Cool. So happy that I saw it. It's making all the animating so much easier. Doesn't it, Crescent Sign? Isn't it animating it? It's so nice because it's got the little animation preview window and the frame by frame thing. And I like it a lot. I like it a lot. Think of PHP as a middleman between your database and the client. That's a good way to put it. Good idea. HTML is front end. PHP is server side. That's a good way to put it too, Smith. Yeah. So yeah, you need HTML. You can have just PHP, I guess, but it's still rendering HTML at the end of the day. I guess, is this it? Gray, white, Runa, light. Is it really from the colors? There's a world library. There's these main colors, world sprites. I guess that's it. That's all I got. Where do the violet colors come from? What? GT! 6 months! Can we get some hype and hearts in chat, please? That half a year anniversary!
Hashtag dispixelert. Alert, hashtag banana suit, hashtag banana hoodies, hashtag jerk stream kappa.
Hashtag dibs pixel art, hashtag jerk stream. GG Grace, thank you so much for 6 months of support, dude. Thank you for hanging out that long and not getting sick and tired of my face. I appreciate it. And we're actually doing some pixel art today, so you chose a good day to hang out. We're doing some pixel art of Skeleton Finn. So hopefully you're interested in that. And if not, you can just take that banana hoodie back. I was mostly just lurking. Anyways, no worries, Elmer. Where to look for interactive viewer avatars, which I spotted on some streams. People usually make those themselves, Kachanak. Can another sub help me out? How do I get to the Discord, Harris? The Discord instructions are over here. Oh, thanks, Smith. You're awesome. Jerks. Jerks! What's up, GT? How you doing, dude? So where the hell does the colors come from this? You have mold on your face? What? Oh, this. Ah, damn it. Green screen. Thought we had it today. Thought we had it. What is it? Filters. Oh, is it when I lean too far forward? No, I don't know when it is. Filters, chroma key. I guess we're going to have somewhat of a green outline. All right, let me know if the green screen starts going through my face again. We'll deal with a little bit of a green outline. Nowadays, you have a backend using data persistence to business logic interfacing with front end inside your browser to an API, which your controls to draw your templates according to state. Serious answer, dude. Serious answer. Okay, so it is hard-coded. Damn it. Well, we will continue to hard-code crap. So this is Skele. And this is Skele. So let's check our colors. So back in Photoshop. This is the main color for skeletons. They're going to be brown. And that is our RGB, 89, 64, 62. 89, 64, 62, right? Is that what I said? 89, 64, 62. And this is the lighter ones. We're gonna make it like this. It's gonna look like mud. 176, 147, 140. 176. Oops. 147. So these really, I mean, I did them originally because I liked having like super fine control over stuff, but we probably should have just made a, this isn't an every player skin, we probably should just make a little library for these colors at some point. Try some fake tan. What? Disappointment. I guess that recent message didn't come through the IRC. That's weird. Interesting. You need some forehead powder today. I should get some. Is it super bright? I feel extra brighted today. Such brightness. Okay, so Skeleton should now have a brown color. Meaning, let's try a match out here. Oh, I did one more thing too. Check this out. Now when you play the game. I don't know if you guys can hear it, but it's playing the Ghost Ship song. Bye, Slovenian Devil! Okay, so I'm going to pick Skeleton. Oh. I don't have them? What the hell is that? Control F1? There he is. That's weird. Why did I just lose access to him? Oh, because he's not technically unlocked. How do you have pre-alpha of Convention Tycoon? What do you mean, Einstein? Oh, do I have pre-alpha of Convention Tycoon? I do not. Okay, so you can see now Finn's flag down here is brown. Because his skeleton is a brown skin. Banana suit had 200 followers? What? What's up, Milton? How's it going? That is an adorable little doggy emote. Okay, so the color thing is good now. So let's work on fixing up our pumpkin first. I keep procrastinating this, I'm never gonna get it done, and then I'm gonna be in trouble. So let's make our pumpkin guy. Let's grab our stylus, drink some coffee. Maybe we won't drink that coffee anymore today. Not sure when I put that coffee there, actually. So what we're looking for here is just areas to clean up the pixels. So places where the pixels could be a better order. Places where the pixels are missing and should be there. Places where the count of pixels, so you always want to go like you never want to go, what's the term for it? It's like you don't want to go like one pixel and then 3 pixels and then 2 pixels, right? Unless you're trying to make some really drastic changes. So you want like nice curves. So you're kind of looking out for stuff like that. Like right there. So we don't want 2, 1, 1, 2. We want 1, 2, 1, 2. If that makes any sense. If it doesn't, let me know and I could try to explain what I'm talking about. You typically make your sprites in 64-64 block? I don't. No, SkyUp doesn't adhere to any like super strict rules like that. So my characters are all like 40 by 70 or something. And then these menu sprites, I make them whatever size I want to for the menu. So I don't adhere to any like crazy strict pixel art rules. Oops. I can't wait for Convention Tycoon to be in a fully playable state. I've already gotten one streamer super interested in because on chat and cheer integration. That's awesome, Elmer. Thanks, dude. I just stopped with the coffee, had an absolutely awful caffeine withdrawal headache yesterday. Ah, that sucks, Hager. I'm trying to get myself to slowly become less and less reliant on coffee. I would love to be coffee independent, but that day is not here yet. That day is not here yet. Because that coffee was from last week. I think it was from yesterday, maybe. Or maybe just something fell in it. I don't know. It tasted really sour. I don't think coffee's supposed to be sour, is it? But yeah, it's going to be... Convention Tycoon hopefully be in a playable state soon, but it's going to be a little while before we actually have, you know, have a build that we can send out to streamers and stuff like that. What I have accepted is that Convention Tycoon is going to take much longer than I originally was hoping for. I can't seem to... Even no matter how much I shrink down the scope, which I have quite a bit, I can't seem to get it to be small enough where I can actually finish it in a short period of time. So I have accepted that it's, you know, it might take us somewhere into next year to finish it. So like somewhere early next year, hopefully. You need to have fire flickering from the mouth and the eyes. Oh, the sprites and the menus aren't animated, so we won't be able to do that. But that would have been super cool. Clean up those, add a line here. Trying to make it look a little lumpy. So who in chat is excited for the next Quasi Jam in November? Do you plan on releasing Convention Tycoon as early access first, or do you just plan to finish it before release? I don't plan on doing early access. Yeah, I didn't really enjoy the early access process from my previous game. If anything, what I'll do is, you know, an early alpha for people on Twitch and maybe people on itch.io, just like a, you know, just like a play it before it's done kind of a thing, but not really an early access. I don't know if that makes sense. More like testing alpha, like testing builds and stuff, for you guys. But I don't plan on doing any like formal early alpha kind of deals. I didn't really enjoy doing early access with. I kept saying early alpha. I'm going to say early access. I didn't really enjoy doing early access with Skyhook. I see a lot of like negatives to doing early access now. I think it works for some kind of games. I think Tycoon games are those kind of games as well. But the danger of being in early access I saw as well is that I can get stuck in working on that game for even longer than I originally intended to, you know? Probably be back Wednesday. See you, Stixy. Have a good one. Quasi Jam, Shanna? Yeah, if you guys don't know what Quasi Jams are, they are game jams that we host here on the stream. So every month or every few months we host Quasi Jam. We're currently on our 8th game jam, and everyone gets together. People form teams. A lot of people work on their own. We all vote on themes together, and then for 48 hours, everybody jams on a brand new game that we then put up for download on itch. In fact, you guys can see the games from Quasi Jam 7 right over here. Can you explain the Quasi Jam? I'm new, of course, Penguin. Yeah, check it out. This was the jam we just finished back in September. Quasi Jam 7. We had 25 games made by 25 amazing human souls. And then we sacrificed them to increase my lifespan. Hopefully I'll be able to Quasi Jam, but I have unexpectedly got to get ready to move out as my landlord is selling my house, so I got to find a new place. Potato, that really sucks. Holy crap. Damn, that really sucks. Your landlord's just selling the house that you live in. Which, oh man, I hope you find a place soon, dude. Sounds like fun. Is it similar to Ludum Dare? It is, yeah. So it's similar to Ludum Dare, except there's no competition, which I believe Ludum Dare doesn't do anymore either. There's no competition. I stream my jam process. A lot of people stream their jam process. And instead of the theme being super public, or instead of the theme voting being public, the theme voting is decided by you guys in chat. So a few days before, the way it works is a few weeks before the jam, subscribers will start submitting theme ideas, and then we'll pick the best ones, and then those will be open up for voting by people who, by anyone who watches the show. And so you guys kind of get a, you know, direct hand in what the theme of the game jam is going to be. Our last game jam was themed black and white. Don't know if Ian and Settle to do the jam. I know, Potato, that really sucks. But don't worry, there'll of course be more jams in the future. So hopefully once you're settled into your new place. I'm stunned that it hasn't been happened at this house yet. They're gentrifying the whole neighborhood and putting up 700k houses. So surprised they haven't sold this one to be knocked over yet. Ah, Neville, hope that doesn't happen to you too, dude. That would suck. Next Quasi Jam, Quasi Mom better win. I hope not.
Oh, yeah.
And Wheeze, thank you for the host, dude. How's it going? Welcome, everybody, from Wheeze's channel. You're just in time to watch us pixel some pumpkin faces. We are currently working on the Halloween update for my game Skyhook, which is out now on Steam. And we're doing it by doing some Halloween-themed pixel art. Sounds like Seattle. When is next Quasi Jam, Zelda? I haven't decided on a date yet. It's definitely going to be in October. I was originally going to do the weekend of October 4th, 5th, and 6th, but that weekend's also Extra Life, so I don't want anyone who's planning on doing Extra Life or watching Extra Life streams to miss out on the jam. So I decided against that. So I haven't picked a date yet, but it'll probably be sometime in November, just sometime that's not Thanksgiving and sometime that's not the first week of November, since that's when Extra Life is. So I guess that'll probably be like the week of the 14th and stuff. I'll let you guys know once we get closer to it, the exact date. All right, so we want to put some shine here to show depth. Maybe not so much. That one pixel under right under the eye really looks out of place. Good catch. Thanks, dude. Wheeze, think I'm lying about liking the taste of 100 proof bourbon? Oh, gosh. When is the first 3D quasi game release, Pie Assassin? That's a good question. Well, the game we're... our most recent project is 3D. So Convention Tycoon, the game we were talking about earlier, if you haven't seen it yet, is a 3D game. My next game is basically going to be 3D no matter what. What I've been thinking lately is, since Convention Tycoon is probably about, maybe 6 to 8 months away from, like, probably gonna take me about six or eight months. What I might want to do in the meantime is, I really, really, really want to release one more game this year. Like, I really want to. I've only released one game this year. I don't want that to be the only game I release this year. And there's not much time left in the year. I've only got 2 months left. So I really want to try to squeeze out, just really squeeze out one more game. Even if it doesn't, at least get it like ship ready if I can't release it because of like holidays or something. But I would love to have it actually released, like one more game this year. No matter what, whatever game it is that comes out next is going to be 3D, most likely. Most likely. Unless it just happens to work better in 2D. Cleaning up pixel art. Can you draw small art like this without pixel art so that all curves look like vector illustration like? Or is it small so you have to draw it like this? I would just make it bigger. I don't really do vector art. Even if I wanted to, I don't really know how, but yeah, I mean, you could just paint this, right? So this pixel art's actually pretty big, but you can just draw this pumpkin. See, pretty much the same thing. Everyone, let's squeeze Quasi TV so another game pops out. Been broken for 10 minutes. What happened, Einstein? Pixar is so cool. I love how little things change so dramatically, right? That's a good thing, and it's also a really annoying and scary thing. It's a really, really annoying and scary thing because you can just like break your pixel art so easily. But it's kind of like meditative as well once you get like really into it. Okay, what am I missing? Oh, the mouth, inside the mouth. Is this pumpkin used for catching ducks? What? What are you talking about? Do people use pumpkins for catching ducks or something? I didn't know that. That. So you want to kind of show the depth a little bit here. I catch all my ducks by flinging pumpkins at them. She has a good video quality. Thanks, Michael. Yeah, that's a lot to do with the new computer that we have. It can actually render my camera at full resolution and render my monitor at full resolution. I'm not actually not downsampling anymore, I don't think. I think I am still downsampling at 720p just for bandwidth, actually. But yeah, it used to be a lot worse before. Oh, the green stock. I forgot to color that in. I keep putting off making a new computer. I know. Dude, it's so worth it. Uh-oh. I got the internet, but not the CPU graphics. Dude, I'm on the 1070 now. Oh my goodness, guys. I was on the 760 before. 660, sorry. My old graphics card was a 660. Do you not use your pumpkin for catching ducks? I don't. I was on the GTX 660 before we got this new PC, and now I'm on the 1970. What's the latest graphics card? What's my graphics card? Properties, devices, display adapters, 1070. That's what I was, 1070. What is the soundtrack? Ori and the Blind Forest, 1070. Which, like, oh gosh, feels so good. Thanks, guys. Yeah, not the 1080. So I asked what's the latest, just so I could minus one. I know it's one behind the latest one. I know the latest one is 1080, and so I have the one behind that. Because 1080 is like dumb expensive. Like, just dumb expensive. How much did your computer cost me? In total, the computer was $1,600, I believe. Yeah, I think it was $1,600. I hope it'll last me another 8 years again. Show us the case of the PC. I will, Aislinn. I'm still waiting on the... I don't want to show it until I have the laser engraving ready. So I haven't shown it yet, but I swear I will once all that stuff is ready. It's been super busy around here, but once I can get it all engraved, I can do it. What? Michael! 7 months in a row! Can we get some hearts and hype in chat? 7 months. Michael J. Calkins, thank you so much for 7 freaking months of support, dude. You're amazing. And I love you. And I hate your guts also. Thank you so much, dude. One of the machines I installed on that museum had ATI Fire Pro. It's a 3K graphics card with 6 head output. God damn. You see the Titan Z, I know. I know, Slark. Holy crap. Latest in the Titan XS. Oh, okay. I was talking about... Oh, yeah. I guess I meant in the 10 lines, but... Quadros are also crazy expensive. They are, yeah. Yeah, I forgot about the Titan lines. My bad. So we're gonna put some more shading in this guy. This will just give it a little bit more depth, hopefully. Not too much. I still keep forgetting to clean up that stock. Spooky! What's up, James? And this color just needs to be a darker orange. Like a that. No. Like that. Is your network broken again? Nope, you're good. The spoopy emotes. Okay, the stock. Yeah. And then we should be about done. We can move on to better, more fun things like the characters. So you guys are just tuning in. We are working on the Halloween update for my game Skyhook, which is a 2D platformer out now on Steam. It's a game where you fight with grappling hooks. And we are getting everything ready for the upcoming Halloween holiday. I think that's okay. Don't want to make the stock too apparent. Okay, let's see how it looks in game. Actually, this should be a little bit lighter. Drawing to Caprec takes OE tags, and I can't tell if my sub messages, if it gives me sub messages, I guess I don't really need those anyway. That sucks. The Tribute Games game? No, that's Flint Hook, James. Tribute Games is making Flint Hook. Oops! The joke pumpkin I put over there is showing through. Let's go back. You got 10 days to finish. I still got a commission for a Halloween layout. 10 days, get started. All right, there we go. So this icon is about done, I would say. Versus quest, versus quest, versus quest. All right, and now let's get back to work on Skeleton. Who's this guy right here? He's a skeleton. Rip joke pumpkin, I'm sorry. Joke-a-lantern, F. Paying that respect, Hastein. All right, so yep, you're good and you're good. So let's jump over here. So we're gonna grab these eyes. This is one thing we're gonna add to our animation. And then we're gonna animate the rest of him. So last week we worked on all of his heads. We have a couple more heads to fill in, mostly just the melee head, the dead head, and we could just fix these dodging heads. Joke Pumpkin should have an Easter egg. You guys and your Easter eggs. So let's add the green eyes here. We're gonna do it on a new layer, actually. First, get rid of that pixel. It does look way cooler with the green and glow in the eyes. Because before, without the eyeball, these characters, these sprites didn't have much personality, you know? And now they have a little bit of personality, which is cool. These ones we have to do by hand. I believe, yeah. And these, this one we could do. So we're just filling in all the standard eyes, and the other eyes we'll have to do separate. Because remember, there's three different heads. There's up, down, left, and right. Or up, down, forward, and a couple of variations in that. That's up. This one needs to be, oops. This one definitely needs to be reanimated to like look down a little bit more. Hey, Tiny Roboduck! Lots of animation frames? Yeah, indeed. Just like your game, what's the game you're working on, James? Skyhook should read Spoopy Hook? Oh gosh, looks pretty cool. Thanks, Blank. Joke Pumpkin was better, to be honest. Damn. Damn, shots fired. Green eye holes. Everybody's got their green eye holes. Pike and shot? What's that? You feel free to drop a link or anything, or a screenshot or trailer of your game. I'd love to check it out. Have you tried A-Sprite? I have not. I've seen it though. It's cool. It's definitely cool. I'm, you know, pretty happy with the tools and stuff I have in PixelEdit. I'm off to pick up the kids from school. See you, Elmer. Have a good one. F. Hotshire? What? Okay. So, yeah, he's already looking so much cooler, right? Like, just having done that, you're giving him green eyes. So let's go work on his melee head. So we need to do is animate this head, chomping the crap out of the other heads. Here's your devlog, cool. Pike in shot. Pike and shot gameplay. Interesting. So are you controlling the entire group of people? Trying to see what the gameplay is. Two main buttons of control, a pike and a shot. Give fire and let loose volleys and lead one out. That's kind of a cool idea. Huh. That's a really interesting premise for a game. You're marching and choosing. Oh, that's really cool. And then they have to actually knock their arrows to reload and stuff. Really cool. Currently working on my game, got all the base game, now to work on the look of the game. What's your game again, Potato? I finally released my Fallout mod after working on it for 2 months. Can you post a link to it? Absolutely, Titan. You control them like a shoot-'em-up ship. Gotcha. That's a really cool idea. All right, let's get to work on the melee attack of this guy here. So here's our sprite. Here's our drawing area. Here's our sprite sheet. It keeps resetting, so let's just make a copy of this so you guys can see it. You want to always be able to see what we're actually animating. It's super helpful. Okay, so melee. We can start by copying his main body. Pixel edit for the win! Nexus mods, the depths below. Settlers at Hangman's Alley are being attacked, and it's up to you to put a stop to it. But things are not what they appear to be. Discover the shadowy train station and unravel the mystery of the depths below. Cool, dude. How long have you been working on this? I think you said... after working on it for 2 months. Awesome. A mystery? Okay, so we're basically going to animate just the head right now. That's what we're worried about the most. So let's do it to it. Just trying to get a little comfortable. Trying to get size. What do you think about Clip Studio Paint? I have it, and it's awesome. Clip Studio Paint is an excellent, excellent drawing program, especially for making comic books and stuff. I actually bought it. They had a sale. They have sales pretty frequently, but they had a sale recently for it was like $50 or something for the whole program. And I was like, hell yeah, hell yeah. You're a witch's assistant. You run around, gather ingredients from around the room while avoiding traps. Been working on it for 2 weeks. Cool. I only really play 2 and 3. Yeah, I haven't played 4 actually yet. Hopefully someday when I'm a grown up. So here's where we should probably show that his jaw is detached, right? Because jaws usually hinge on the skull. Do they hinge above the skull or under the skull? I don't think his other sprites quite show that enough, actually, if you look at it. Like, they don't show the disconnect between the lower jaw and the upper jaw. I feel like there should have been a pixel here on all the heads. Is a lot worse in Photoshop, or is it too different to compare? They're very similar, I think. It's just they're meant for different purposes, right? Like, Photoshop is meant for, I would say, I'm trying to sound like I'm putting them, like lumping them into groups. But yeah, like what's cool about Clip Studio Paint is all the art you do is vectorized, I've heard. And so that's kind of cool, because then you can, it's like good for making t-shirts and stuff. And if you're doing like graphic work. So all your lines are automatically vectorized, I believe, which is like super awesome. Okay, so I'm disconnecting the lower jaw and all the sprites here. How does a skeleton have a ghost? I guess they still do. Okay. There's some overlap with the lower jaw being above the skull, but I'm no biologist. I don't know if it's like that for all skulls. Let's check out shark skulls. Probably should have checked it out before I read you all the skulls. These are what shark skulls look like. Looks like, yeah, there's a little indent there, which is what we were just coding in or pixeling in. Not as much as I thought I would imagine, actually. Yeah, so we just drew in that little joint. Looks like it should have came down lower, but that's okay. Shark skulls also look disgusting. They're not super cool. The shark skull in the game is actually like totally fake, right? Like, this is a real shark skull. Not that cool looking. Like, not, and they don't have, you know, like the fin is not involved or whatever. This is like a real shark skull. Like, looks kind of terrible. So we totally faked it in Skyhook to make it look super cool. Gotta put the little teeth in for the bite animation. Wait, what happens here? Oh, I see. So if that's, so the teeth are actually this white color to show that they're there, to really emphasize them, which means we use this gray color to show the gap or the line between the teeth and the skull. Something like that. It's pretty much a T-Rex. Not afraid to admit it. Finn was actually based on a T-Rex shark character that I designed a long time ago. His skull looks more like a dinosaur, like a T-Rex shape. Yeah, absolutely, JC. Absolutely. But that's what makes him look cooler, too, though. I feel like if he looked like a regular shark, he wouldn't look pretty. He wouldn't look very cool. T-Rex shark, you better believe it. Got to watch Quads today. What's up, Brian? I feel like, so here he's supposed to have closed his eyes, right? But skeletons can't close their eyes because they're skeletons. So I guess I'll just turn off his pupil then. Like, how do skeletons blink? I don't want him like looking up like he's having like an orgasm or something. I guess we could just make him look forward the whole time, like a creeper. T-Rex skull separates all the way to the back when I looked at it, so pretty much like you're doing it. Oh, perfect. Yeah. T-Rex shark it is. Maybe in the Skyhook world, sharks evolved from T-Rexes instead of from fishes. It's a thing. It could be a thing. Gotta get out and get some lunch. See you later. Bye, Shanna. Have a good one. I would just turn off his eye light. Yeah, I think that's a good idea. So it looks like he closed his eyes. Robot skeleton? What? This is a good template for Mechafin. Who was it that was a huge fan of Mechafin back in the days? Not much is up? Well, that's a good thing, I guess. Turn off his pupil. I know, right? Video game conversations. So we have a really exaggerated chomp here, right? So we really bring his face forward, his jaw gets ginormous. So you really feel that chomp in game. Roosharks don't close their eyes when they bite. They roll their eyes back into their heads to protect them. Oh, that's true. They can't close their eyes, can they? They don't have eyelids. That is a really cool thing to know. Well, that's exactly what Skeleton is doing. He's rolling his eyes back. That's why when a shark really goes for a chomp or something that perceived as dangerous, their eyes go white. What? Really? I did not know that. Super cool. All the dinosaurs, then birds, T-Rex, shark. Concrete is all you see. Hey, Stein, you're a fan. I'm also a fan of online multiplayer. Damn, hey, Stein! It is a bit creepy. Do you sub to get an early version of games you're developing? I need an excuse to sub. That hasn't been 100% decided yet. I have to figure out the logistics of that as we get to our next game. If by early version you mean like a free copy of the game, then that's what I'm not sure of is what I mean, because we did like free copies of Skyhook and we're no longer doing that. They'll most definitely get like down, some will definitely get like downloadable alphas of the game, like testing builds and stuff like that. You guys have been super important to like the testing of all the games we develop here. When people's eyes went white when we chomped on things, that would be so cool, Slark. Are you kidding me? I wish they did now. I'm just gonna try to figure out how to make my eyes go white when I chomp on things. Like, how cool would it be? Our eyes just don't go white enough, you know what I mean? Early episodes of Convention Tycoon and such? Yeah, absolutely. Probably should start including that in the sub benefits. Someone followed using a deviation of your nickname? Oh no, no pill? Neo pill? Oh, Neo pill. Not no pill. That's funny. Also, Neo pill, thank you for the follow and welcome. For every bit we do an exorcism, for every bite we do an exorcism. Underjaw grooves a lot when taking a bite. Yeah, it does. Chomp, chomp. The stressed out chomp frame reminds you of old Disney movies like Aladdin. Animators would draw some frames all wacky and rubber banded, looking to help make the motion fluid when sitting on speed. Exactly, yeah. Exaggerating like one or two frames in your animation really helps in kind of like pushing it even further so that people can feel it more, you know? Is this the same as the downhead? Can I just steal the downhead for this? Let's bring it down a little bit. it goes down even further. Chomp. And then it comes back up. It's down, and then this is going back one frame too many. Or one pixel too much. Chomp. And this is going too high. There we go. Now you should be able to see like a nice little. You can see some little chomps when my first boss dies and turns into a wolf. What? Dies and turns into a wolf? You don't really hear that very often. Holy crap, that's crazy! What? He dies and a bunch of wolves come and eat him and then turns him into a wolf? That is really creative. I love the pixel art, dude. Holy crap. Look at this, guys. The dude dies, a bunch of wolves come, and then they start biting his body as he screams in pain. Blood comes out, then all the wolves leave, and then he turns into a wolf, and then he rises again. Holy crap. And then he howls. That is some sweet pixel art. His wolf pack eats him. Yeah, apparently. Only sharks that lack a nictitating membrane roll their eyes back. What's a nictitating membrane? Sounds hot. So Skeleton doesn't have this belt, so we can get rid of all these belts. So as you guys can probably tell, I'm really procrastinating animating all of his bodies because goddamn, that can be a lot of work. Now looking forward to animating all those bodies. I don't want to make him wear a belt. Wait, what the hell is that? Why is there a belt in this frame? It's just coming out from the previous. Nope. Did have a belt. I guess because it just didn't look good. Just probably been too many things going on his waist. I don't know. Probably. Why would a skeleton wear belts anyway? Boots and pants? What's up, SMB? It's a thin layer that protects their eyes. Gotcha. You'll nictate my brain membrane? Thanks, Neville. He has a wolf pack with him. Gotcha. That's super cool. I love your pixel art, dude. I'm assuming you did the art. I love that the wolves even have a turning animation. Man, now I'm starting to wonder if you should be wearing a belt. What do you guys think? Should Skeleton have a belt on? Kind of like him without the belt. Makes him more different than regular Finn, I guess. Okay, so what other frames is he missing? Dead frames, which are these hit frames, which is the same as this. Belt is just noise, you want them to see the bones. Good call, Neville, yeah, good point. Have you seen Daniel's new game logo? Are you serious? Is this his new logo? Because that is freaking amazing. Is this really the logo? Damn, he did a good job. This is amazing. Space cats with lasers. Hell yeah. That is so good. Klaatu, Barada, and Nictate. What? Are you casting a spell, James? Are you trying to cast a spell on us, dude? Not cool. Not cool. All right, let's export this and take a look at it. File name Finn Skeleton, over without asking, yes please. Good idea for a game, you have a camera, if you take a picture it takes the region out of the actual world, then you can print that region out to the actual world again in different places. You can solve puzzles, that's cool. This will get smaller regions when more close up and bigger the further away, then you'll be able to scale them depending on if you're standing further away. So you'll be able to place boxes to parkour your way over the end of a level. That's a really cool idea. I have no idea how you would implement I don't know how we would actually make that work, but that's a really cool idea. All right, so now he can chomp and chomp and chomp and chomp. Oh, look, I made this one change too. Previously in the main menu, if you chomp other people, all I did was get knocked back a little bit, but now they go flying forward. Because what I'm actually prototyping, or I was looking, the reason I prototyped that is I want to try a new game mode. And maybe we'll do it today if we get bored or want to have some fun. I'm interested in trying a Smash-like game mode. So like a damage game mode where when you do melee to each other, it actually just like increases your percent damage, right? And then you can get knocked back further. So I want to try like a Super Smash Bros. Game mode, basically, where it's not instant kill. Instead, like every hook hit and every melee attack just increases your damage and, you know, you can get knocked off stage. It's like the Portal series in a way. It is, yeah. Except really, really, really hard. New game mode, .. Going to other players and beating them up. Yeah, you can. Most people who play the game don't actually know that. So you guys know that and you can surprise your friends. Why not online multiplayer? Hey, Sign, that's not exactly a game mode. It's a little bit more than a game mode. I guess maybe it's a 2D platformer where you cannot move on the Z-axis. Oh, if it's a 2D platformer, I guess that's more realistic. I guess I was thinking 3D. Like, even as a... I guess if you make it puzzle-based, then... that's really interesting, dude. Are you going to make it? Oh, I see something here. These black lines should not be there. He should probably open his eyes around here somewhere. So it's like he starts opening it and then it's all the way open. Which I guess we just have one dot, so we can't do much with that. Yeah, we gotta fill in all the eyes, don't we? What is this terrible looking game? Damn, Stets. Damn. I think there's a game like that. Picture one from a few years ago. What's it called? Gotta read the Hunger Games first for school. Priorities. It would increase the amount of people playing. I don't think it would. The game's kind of already past that point, you know, where it would grow community and stuff, I think. At this point, it's a discoverability problem, so it's not really worth it. And also, I don't have the resources to make it anyway. So if you look at there's a lot of like local multiplayer games kind of suffering from the same thing where they have online multiplayer, but people, you know, you still need a lot of people to play online multiplayer games. Here, we're gonna put the eye looking up. Let's go copy this looking up eye hole to all the other ones. Bet you have your moment, sorry. Just because there's a game that's similar to your idea doesn't mean you shouldn't make it. Imagine what happened to Minecraft if he was like, well, Dwarf Fortress is similar to my idea. Never would have had it. I was going to say, keeping up to your game, because I don't think it would have that much of an impact on sales. Yeah, the updates are for the current owners, right? They're not really for new owners. The updates are so that, you know, people who own the game can get more content and more stuff to play, because I don't want to abandon them. Overcooked suffers without online multiplayer if anyone has played it. Overcooked suffers without online multiplayer. Anyone has played it. Well, the weird thing about these like party games, right, is that they're not the kind of games that have, even like Overcooked, right? Like Overcooked is freaking awesome. Like I love that game. But they don't necessarily have the kind of game loop where you can play them in like, I feel like in long competitive rounds, you know? Like SkyX suffers from the same problem. So it's like, with online multiplayer, you need people who want to be playing it just for endless hours and hours and hours. And I just don't think that exists for some of these kind of game types. But I don't know, I could be wrong too. You abandoned Skyhook? That's cool. It's kind of hard to do as a local multiplayer game. Absolutely, yeah. I don't think, for anyone who's working out there, I don't think there is any place for local multiplayer games to succeed outside of small kind of gems like Overcooked that have, you know, some good marketing around them. The patch notes on Dwarf Fortress are more entertaining than Minecraft. Damn, Blood Ridge. How's new PC stats? It's doing good. New PC is freaking awesome. What's up, Bambi? How's it going? Okay, now we have our down eye. We can copy that around. You're sick! Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Did you large the phallic shape engrave like I asked? What? What's the question? Okay, that's all of those. That's good. That's eyes closed. We just need one of these. Unreal Engine 4 just crashed your PC, oh crap. What were you doing in it? Too many models? You got stuff engraved on the PC, okay. No, not yet. I haven't got a chance to get out to the store yet. I had a kind of a crazy weekend, but hopefully this week I can get there. I don't know if he should turn his head. I love local multi-games, and I wish I had a local group of friends to support playing it. Yeah, I feel you. One of my friends made battle slots? Cool, and I'm never going to really get to play it in full extent. But I wouldn't ask him to make an online multiplayer version because that's not what it was designed for. I think Skyhook is the same way. It was intended for local play and developed with that in mind. It wouldn't be the same game online. Yeah, it really just wouldn't. It's just not a game that I don't think you can play for that long anyway. Like, it was made to be a really, really short game. So I feel like the online multiplayer community wouldn't stay around for very long, simply because it's not a game that you're meant to be playing for hours and hours. Like, it wasn't designed to be played for hours. Like games like, you know, Street Fighter or Smash or other better online games. And, you know, I'm fine with that. I know what I made. The software I'm using free, I think like $12 or something, or $10. Pixelate. But there are some good free alternatives as well. A-Sprite is one of them. Someone showed me a new one recently. Ace Pixel or something? I forget what it was, but it was cool. Cats dying for no reason, alcohol poisoning, Dwarf Fortress patch notes. That's awesome. Guys, I really don't want to animate his body. Can we just make him a floating head? Ace Sprite? Yes, that's what it was. No, wait. That's what we already talked about, isn't it? I forgot. What are the two we talked about? Toja, what's up? Can we just... Oh, I'm missing this sprite. Can we just make him a floating head? I don't want to animate his body. Seems like a lot of work. What will be easier and more satisfying is the other ones. Animal breeding is prevented if animals aren't willing to marry. What's up, L Chicken Nugget? The fusion is a little old, yeah. Chompity chompity dodgity dodge. Chompity chompity dodgity dodge. What else does he do? I think those are all the moves, right? Wall size missing the eye, okay. And that one is fine. Swing is good. I think wall slide is missing the eye. And what? Why are the players sorting in front of that? Crap. Crap, 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 crap. Halloween ship. Where is it? There it is. How long have you been doing these Skyhook update stats? We started on Friday, so this is day 2. 2 days so far. Ship body. So this should be on the vehicle layer, I guess. Moon snail men can't punch or see. Oh, crap. That's why I did it like that. So I want this part to be in front of the players. Damn it. Proof people with mustaches are above people with mustaches. What? You like the shark's dodge? Thanks, James. Floating head works with Halloween. True, Toja. True. Crap, guys. Sorting nightmares. So the top of the ship needs... Okay, I know what to do. The bottom of the ship needs to be a separate sprite from the top of the ship. So this needs to be a sprite. And this needs to be a sprite. Because one has to be in front of the player, so it looks like they're standing behind the ship. Select that. And where's the ship body? Ship body, ship body. Okay, select that, and then... Nope. What? You like graphics? Thanks, Drunk Bears. How's the mod working out for you? Liking it still? It's okay. I've been meaning to switch and try out Nightbot and haven't had a chance yet. I definitely do miss Ankhbot, and I need someone to remind me to get our update out of the old computer. Mubot's nice. It's some of the stuff that I want is like you have to pay for it, which is kind of frustrating. Oh crap. I broke it. What just happened? Oh, I didn't apply the prefab. Phantom bot is great. What's that? There we go. Okay. So now he sorts behind the ship, as you can see up here in the top corner. There's just a little gap, it looks like. I tagged you with a message to update in Discord General. Hopefully you'll get the notification next time you're online. I don't know how Discord works with that though. Cool, yeah, after I stream I should actually get alert for it. Maybe that'll remind me. Thanks, dude. You help stats, thanks. Ankhbot forever, and didn't no one remind you in the Discord group after you asked? Nope. You jerks! One thing you guys are good for. Ankhbot basically, but better in my opinion. Phantom Bot. Let's see. Phantom Bot. Multi-purpose Twitch chatbot. I'll check it out after stream. Thanks, dude. Ooh, it looks really fancy. Is it in the cloud? Alerts, announcements, nightly builds, steady releases, open source. Keeps chat going. Okay, I'll check it out after stream. Looks cool though. What's up, Jeffy? You love more follows? Thanks, Snoop Loops. I appreciate it. And thanks for the follow as well. Okay. So, could make one of the other ones because it'll be, would it be easy? Let's take a look at Anara's spreadsheet. Okay, I need to take a break from skeletons. So I have a very low, endurance for pixel, for animating, I think. I got tired really quickly. I'm on a max, so I had to find something that I could use. Oh, cool. How's it going, Toshtron? It's going good. It's going real good. We're working on the Halloween update for Skyhook. You can enter the stream, but you can't leave. Fanabot's open source, so it can be modified to your heart's content. Ooh, cool. I'll take a look at that. Because he has no heart? You better believe it, Stetsmendo. Where my heart used to be, there's just a Magikarp now. I'm talking about bots and subs. Do you have to actually subscribe from your bot, or do you have the ability to give your bot as a sub channel owner? Yeah, I think you get like one when you're part of a streamer. You can ask Twitch to give you one, like Bot Quasi was sub to our channel, right? So I asked Twitch and they subbed the bot to me. Are you starting to forget the Sky code structure since you're not working on it anymore very often? Yeah, I mean, luckily I have ReSharper, right? So a lot of times I'll just start typing like kill, and I'm like, oh, kill the player, or I'll start typing like player skin, and like, okay, there's skin classes. So I, you know, my code is not great for the game because it was my first game, but the classes are still decently named, so I can find stuff and look through it. I do remember quite a bit still, like how most of the structure works. It's not that long ago and I'm still in it every now and again. I'm able to find some stuff. The really deep stuff takes me like a minute or two to find it though. Okay, so let's look at Anara's sprite. So what does Anara have? Her head, her face is always the same except for when she flips for her dodge. Otherwise, you pretty much always has the same face, it looks like. So let's try this. Duplicate. I'm gonna rename this to Skelinara. Skelinara. And see how easy it's going to be to change. So this is Skelinara as we have her so far, and it's mostly just replacing her face in a couple of areas and changing her body color. Let's see how easy that's going to be to do. If you play Dragon Ball's Universe, I'm a little disappointed in the 3D models of the characters. They look so ugly. Really? No, I haven't played. The last DBZ game I played was Budokai 3. I haven't played any of them since that. Let's make sure we're keeping the eyes on the right level. What's up, Rantus? What program is this? This is a Pixel Edit. Oh, it's just actually not in the commands. Let me add that back. Come in. How long does it take you to do a random 64x64 pixel art of a random theme? A random amount of time. Tools. Photoshop CS6, Pixel Edit, and Maya. There we go. Pixel Edit. Okay, so now she runs. And yeah, so Skelinara is going to be pretty easy unless we decide to do something bonus to her, which, you know, I don't think she really needs. Maybe we'll just put some holes in her cape or something. Make it more tattered. As a game developer, you have some time reserved to playing games, or isn't it a thing that happens that helps in the career? It absolutely is a thing that helps in the career. I don't have a time reserved to it. It's something that I have to try to force myself to do, yeah. Sometimes I'll force myself to, like, you know, take a whole weekend and be like, okay, I'm only going to play games today. Or I'll, like, set up, like, I have freaking Google Docs where I track games that I want to play. It's sad, man. It's sad. It's really hard to play when you're just like enveloped in developing them all the time. What's other going to encompass Toshatron? It's just going to be a couple of Halloween themed skins and a new Halloween menu. And possibly some new... Oh, actually, there's a couple of stages that we're probably going to add in as well. But they're not... Like, not a new stage, sorry. Like, new variations of stages based on some of the quests. So I can't believe I never thought of this before, but a few of the quests in the game make for really good versus stages. And so we're going to kind of just add those to a list of possible versus stages. Just a little sample of some new content, or a little taste. Right now we're replacing all of her eye holes with skeleton eye holes. Oh, we do need a looking up one. We don't have that. There. I'm afraid my gaming addiction will disturb my learning process in programming as I'm learning ORM framework and it looks like a punch in the nuts. So boring. That sounds really boring. The thing is, like, if you have a gaming addiction, or if you feel like you have a gaming addiction, right? Like, if you want to work on something, if you want to make games, if you want to work on whatever, then it's not going to be a problem. Like, if you find yourself distracted from what you're supposed to be doing, then maybe you don't actually want to do it. That's how I feel about stuff sometimes. Oh, crap. Is there a little white on all these faces? There is. Damn it. But when I really want to work on something, that's all I want to do. And so if I find myself distracted, then I know that I really don't want to work on it. You know? So I want to stop by because I've been super busy. I got to go, but nice to see that you're still wasting everyone's time. So it's Mando, you damn jerk. It was better off when you weren't here. But I'll see you, dude. Definitely miss you. Have a good one. Hope everything's going well. It'll be a little problem in the beginning, but after working on your stuff for a while, you'll start feeling bad wherever you play a game and feel like you're wasting your time. Yeah, I totally agree, Blank. Which kind of sucks, too, because you want to play games and enjoy yourself, right? Like, you want to have a good time playing video games, but you just want to work on your own stuff. So, yeah. Wait, what? I thought we fixed it. Oh, crap. Okay, I need to... This is the old Inara sprite sheet, I just realized. We need to fix that. I almost animated her using the wrong sprite sheet. I was blaming my friends, start working on a project and then get pings from 3 to 4 friends asking to play games. Yeah, I tell those friends. That's how I got rid of all my friends. I started to make games. It's a really good way to get rid of all the friends you don't like. Or do like. Still not available, Brian. I'm sorry, dude. Shoot. We're gonna do this. That new layer. Hide this layer. There we go. Because Inara has a new skin color and new boots in all of the animations. Go back, grab the original. It's always random games for me. No one ever wants to play the same game. Wait, where's the right layer? There we go. So she'll have darker pants and a brown coat. You have to do a skeleton arms. Maybe steer into the skid and learn how to mod Minecraft. That's not a bad idea. This is Skellinar again. So that's a start. We can actually just color all of her skin for now. Give us a starting base on that. Then we can actually cut the holes out in them. Should be super easy, hopefully. Then we have to redo some of these faces and hairs. Well, let's try exporting and see what it looks like. The other thing we have to do is, should they have like bone hooks or something? We can actually give them customized hooks, which for some reason, actually, what's his name is missing it. Yeah, Skeleton is actually missing his hook. So it should just be that. So let's export Skeleton. And then let's export Skellinar. So characters, Anara. Wait, how do we name the other one? Finn Skeleton Skin. So this will be Anara Skeleton Skin. Probably forgets the one thing that his game is based on. Oops. So let's add that in as a skin so we can start seeing it in game. So player skins, Anara. She's got 6 skins so far. Let's make the 7th. This is gonna be her brown skin or her skeleton skin. Oops. Wait, what? You didn't save? Here we go. Anara skeleton skin. That's a flash sprite. Rarity is rare. Super rare. Say rare. Skellinara. Skellinara. Hey, Killer Creeper, how's it going? He makes a chain out of his bones. Jack-o'-lantern hook where the teeth of the lantern are the hook. That's not a bad idea. All right, so now that's a skin. Let's try it out. We have to unlock it first with our keyboard shortcut. Versus Anara, boop, 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 boop. All right, so here's the start. Right now she just looks like an albino ninja, which is still cool, it's not bad. Oh, and she doesn't teleport, she doesn't disappear. That's funny. Her flash step doesn't actually disappear. Does regular Nara disappear? Oh, she doesn't. Oh, I see why. Never mind. It's because it's not a white sprite. That looks way cooler. You can actually see her spin around. Anyway, so now we'll just cut her arm in half so that it has a little, you know, has a little gap in it, so you can looks like it's a bone. That'll mostly solve her. We just got to fix her dodge and her melee. But that's going to be Skellinara. You can't really tell that she's brown, which is annoying. Like the cloth color. Cool. But before we do that, I need to use the old toilet room. So let's fire up some Twitch Play Skyhook. 40 seconds. Type hashtag play in chat right now to join. Let me make sure it works. Okay, it's working. Cool. You guys play a quick match. I'll be back in a second after I use the bathroom.
Yes.
and Krasnstein picks up the boots. If Quads, if you win, did I win? No way. It's awesome. Oh yeah, sorry, the Sky Gold Command isn't working. I think I broke it. Am I hanging out on the ship? Oh, this isn't working anymore. Through an error, you probably need to assign the variable user menu of Twitch example has not been assigned. That's weird. Rigged! Alright, let's get back to pixeling our pixel faces. So. I want to listen to. Yes, it's fine. Your browser just reset? Weird. Maybe your browser is just sick and tired of your shiz, Toja. Alright, don't need this. Go away. Alright, so, Skellinara. What does she look like? Her hands. She just has a split bone right there. Which. We do the stylus. Pixel your pixel face? Better believe it. Better believe it. Should it be like that or should it be like that? I think it should be. Oops. Down, and then her arm is thinner. So we need that background again. That sweet, sweet dark background. That sounded way better in your head. Uh-oh. Okay, so one like that. Power supply broke last week. I got replacement from warranty, but it's now stuck at customs. Oh no, reality, that sucks. You got it imported, I'm guessing. Well, it sucks to hear your power supply got messed up. Okay, so we're gonna make all of her arms thinner because, you know, bony arms should be thinner than fleshier arms. Common rules of being a skeleton ninja. There's just this one frame where it pops. There we go. You're in Canada, it's common practice companies to have stock in USA. Yeah. Why is it like a custom? It's just a power supply. That's bull. My next one last Friday, knowing I wouldn't get anything on time. Was streaming yesterday and can't do that without power. Yeah, definitely not. That sucks. That look bony? That look bony? That looks more bony, right? Some check marks? Maybe it's a random check, could be. I do wish there was something we could do to make this a little bit better. Like to make this character a little bit more Skella, you know, without having to reanimate too much, but I can't quite put my fingers on it. What's going on with this one frame? It's always like that. I Guess it has been. It's not a very good frame. Hold on. Somebody's making a noise in my kitchen. Probably not a good idea to leave the fridge door open. Good thing our fridge has a little beepy beep thing it does when you leave the door open. Always forget the kappa. Okay, so now she's missing a pixel. Here. What is that color? Okay, there we go. I could give her a skeleton feet. High-tech fridge, right, Zelda? Draw a quasi with drawing a painting of quasi drawing a painting of quasi drawing a painting of a banana. Damn it, Brian. We could give her skeleton feet, but will that look dumb? Probably, right? It looks like she has skeleton paws. There's a fridge that can connect to your phone and tablet display on the fridge. You can build a shopping list on your phone sync to. What? That's super fancy. This is what it would look like if she had skeleton feet. What do you guys think? Of a banana drawing a painting of Quasi. Probably need to delete all of her feet first. I'm gonna try this out. So dark, it's hard to see. I think there might be not enough contrast between her pants and her suit. The first has a webcam on the inside so you can see what you need while you're at the store. Oh my gosh. That's cool and also kind of creepy. What if your fridge just wants its privacy, you know? Every fridge deserves its privacy. What do you guys think? Bony feet or skelefeet? Skelefeet or no skelefeet? Hashtag damn it, Zelda. Whoa! Hello? Where am I? I didn't know Windows could do this, but I'm on a different desktop now. I don't know how to get back. And I can't see chat. God damn it. How does this even happen? This thing? You have multiple desktops? Holy crap. Hacker voice, I'm in. Control Windows left, right. What? I know they had this now. That's crazy. Someone donated to him so that it gets read out loud. We can't see chat. Yeah, new virtual desktop. I didn't know they had virtual desktops in Windows 10. Shit. That's scary. Learn something new every day, I suppose. Yeah, I have the Cortana option turned off, but I found the little task view button. Phew! It scared the crap out of me. I didn't know what to do with myself. How about to take my pants off? I didn't know what was the protocol in that situation. In these pants. I think at least the white feet give it something new, so she's barefoot. Best way to hide things in your computer. Feature Windows is pretty handy if you're multitasking, like Art on one, OBS on another, Unity on the other one, like a second monitor, without the cost. Yeah, I didn't consider that. I do need to look at OBS a lot, though. Just to make sure things are working right. But yeah, it's really handy to know about. Thanks, guys. Secret features. OBS is bay. Indeed it is. So walks in your office, just make a new desktop. Well, my office is in the bedroom. It's not usually a problem. Here's where the pants come down, goes up. You pick a pixel out? I like a door frame, it's pretty cool. They updated the AMD plugin? What's that? Who do you guys think? I forgot, did I miss the vote for barefoot or no, not barefoot? What did you guys vote for being barefoot? Let's do it pants. Try to make it so like it looks like the pants are puffing down, but it's super hard to do. The animation interface looks really good. I like it, yeah, it's cool. It's got a little bit of bugs. Have you ever showed your room? I'm interested in what it looks like. I will, not today. It's not quite there yet. Give her bare feet. Bare Inara new skin. Damn it, guys! Yeah, it looks like there's like something like peeking in between her feet if I do this. So let's get rid of that. Get rid of that. Surprised that goes away so quickly. Chaz the master of feature creep. If you run on an Intel integrated or NVIDIA chip, then you can select their boost options. Oh, cool. Just get some brown pixels over there. Let's see, is this looking okay in game? This looks like her scarf just like popped up and down. Assassin with a foot fetish. And I guess it happened in the original. So Nara is one of the oldest sprites, so that's why looking at her animation is driving me crazy. I have to keep myself away from it, right? Because I can mess with this thing for a long time and then end up wasting a lot of time. She was one of the first sprites ever made, meaning she has a lot of errors in her animation. And I can either reanimate all of her or deal with it. Which is really frustrating. Want to see the weirdest dance performed on a Dutch commercial, Brian? No, I don't. No, I don't. Unless this happens to be a ninja skeleton dancing. Good choice. Maybe it needs these lines. Yeah, that seems to help. It's super subtle, but it does something. I guess it separates the brown from the bone. All right, wasting time on her now. It's a fun looking character. Thanks, Cody. How's it going? Time for you to sleep. See you, Zelda. Have a good one. All right, let's throw her in the game. Oops. Oops. Do you have a name for the game? I do. This is actually a game that's out now on Steam. We're working on an update for it. This game is called Skyhook. It was running AMD chipsets and OBS. That is the link I was talking about. Well, I am a NVIDIA guy. So here is Skellinara. It's just a pale barefoot Anara. Which is fine. So let's clean up some of our other sprites so we can get this one done. See you, Brian. Have a good one. Okay, so first up is Run. We're gonna start by making her arm a little bit skinnier. Because it's supposed to be bony. So we're going to lose one pixel on the left edge. Well, Skeleton Finn is wearing shoes and Inara isn't. That's a good point. That's really funny. Well, if you think about it, Skeletonara is a ninja, so she's trying to be as silent as possible. So the clackety clack of her skeleton bones make her too noisy. And it's kind of a mess. Okay. She runs like Naruto, essentially. And so then let's put the, you know, she has the bone missing here, or like the two bones in the forearm. Which is what really makes it look like a skeleton. Skelnar doesn't realize how loud her bones are, and no one has the heart to tell her, so she spends her days being a skeleton ninja. I love it. Okay, and then put some shadows here. We're just gonna occlude most of the arm because it's a skeleton arm. And we did this other thing. Did you see the Sky Noon trailer? It looks similar, but in 3D, it's on Greenlight. I have not. Can you drop a link to that, Cody? Sky Noon? I found it because our game is on Greenland, so I was checking out what else is live. Cool, that's interesting. Wonder which, how similar it is. So you want these, it's hard to make these fingers look bony with so few pixels, right? But we're gonna try. Oh, it opened in another stupid window desktop view. How do I go back this way? Okay. Sky Noon. Whoa. Cowboys. I love the art style. No way, they have grappling hooks? I see it in their hands. Oh crap. No way, that's awesome. That is freaking awesome. This is exactly the kind of game I wanted to make once. Now I can actually find out how fun it is. They better thank you for the promo. That's awesome. Cowboys with grappling hooks and guns and jetpacks. The art is freaking sweet. I can't see the cowboys' faces though. I'm curious what their faces look like. I like the environment art style. Cowboy theme is really interesting for grappling hooks, huh? What is this time robot? Is this Skyhook 2 Electric Boogaloo? Yeah, probably Doorframe. That's awesome. Ooh, can't wait to play it. I love grappling hooks, as you guys can probably tell. Your game is Tyler Model 005. It's a 3D action platformer based off of 9. Cool. Is it on Greenlight as well? Ugh, now we have to pixel out her feet. Looks like the guns don't kill, they just add force. That's an interesting choice. Yeah, like it knock, you just like knock the other person off the level, I'm guessing. Greenlight and Kickstarter, cool. So you said it's a 3D platformer based on 9? What is 9? Painting in her bare feet. Need this color, I guess. From? No, it's more of an edge color. Because she has 3 shaded feet. Darker. Too green. Too dark. It's a movie, kind of a cult following. Oh, you mean 9 little dolls that came to life? What's up, Diver? Pixelart stream? We're working on an update to Skyhook, a Pixelart game that I made. Tyler modeled 005. Oh, it's kind of a long video. Those rats? Ooh, sweet graphics. I would try to cut out. There was like a lot in the beginning that people aren't going to want to sit through. He's adorable. Oh, I do see the inspirations for 9 now, yeah. Yeah, I would recommend like 2.5 minutes is kind of a really long time for a Greenlight or Kickstarter trailer. So it makes it hard to like kind of sit through the whole thing. I know you guys are trying to look a narrative thing. You guys are in, oh yeah, you already know that. Cool. Yeah. Just looking sweet. Looks adorable. That hand. Very cool. When did you guys launch on Kickstarter and Greenlight? Painting skeleton feet is my job. My mom asked me what I do today. I can tell her that I painted skeleton feet, like she always dreamed I would someday. So this hood should flop around a little bit more when she's running. The back does, but the front doesn't flop very much. Let's see, where should it go? When she goes down here, should probably go up a little bit. Then it can come back down, and when she goes up, it can come down a little bit. There we go, so you can see it kind of flapping. Just a tiny little thing. You all mentioned this game in Pixelated Diver. The first year I used Graphic Scale. I actually didn't know about Pixelated. And then the second year I used Pixelated, yeah. So like half in Graphic Scale, half in Pixelated. Graphic Scale is a pretty good free program. It just doesn't lay out the sprite sheets for you. So I used to waste a lot of time putting sprite sheets together myself. But Pixelated and a lot of the new programs now these days will just create the sprite sheets for you like this does. So Graphic Scale is a good kind of like straightforward animation tool, but it doesn't have a lot of little things, little tricks and stuff like Pixelated does. Five days ago? Cool. Well, good luck. What's up, Molten Hard? Coming in with those noseless quasis. Okay, let's do, so we've got idle, got run. Let's do the jump. Start by making each arm, or the ones that are two that are not thin enough, thinner. And then carve in the little holes for the bones. Really should just be the forearm, but I'm like exaggerating it to make it longer. Because the bicep doesn't really have that bone, so let's get rid of that. Or the bicep is one bone, I mean to say. Skylark Halloween update? Yep, indeed. Is there anything you do not do? Music and sound. I don't do that yet. Still haven't had a chance to learn how to do music and sound. But I really want to. I mean, I did the sound effects. I didn't make the sound effects in Skyhook. I bought a lot of them. So, you know, I'll like, you know, try to find good sound effects online. But that's very different from actually making good Foley and stuff, you know. So yeah, I still don't know how to make good music. But I definitely want to. Ironically, that's the one area where I'm just like, huh, what if I just can't do that? Like, for some reason, everything else, I always just assume I can do it. But with music is the one area where I doubt, like, oh, maybe that's one thing I can't do. Alright, and then her boots. So at least, like, keeping her character so simple and so close to the original is saving us a ton of time, right? In terms of updating it. Because again, this is just a small update for a small game. So us investing, I think, more than, like, too many days into this is not going to be worth our time. The update should at least be ready by the end of this week, if not way sooner than that. But yeah, I can't believe Skynoon exists. Wow. That's so cool. I've always had the idea of trying to prototype a 3D Skyhook shooter. But I was never really sure if it would be fun. And what's cool about having games that are similar to the kind of games you want to make is you can actually play them and be like, oh, like, okay, mine might have been a little bit different for whatever reasons, but is this version, like, is their version of the game fun at all? Now we can find out. Without having to make it ourselves. Which is kind of a good thing for me. This should be these feet. I haven't really been showing the toes or anything in the feet, which I'm supposed to be. I can play guitar very basically and a little piano from memory. Nice, Titan. I actually can't play any instruments. It's probably why I'm even less confident about making music. So this should be like that. Character design in Dragon Ball's universe is crappy, but the gameplay is so awesome and nostalgic it doesn't even matter. That's the magic behind video games. So you're actually enjoying Xenoverse then. You're gonna get Macromedia Flash for free? Cool, Brian, what are you gonna do with Flash? I think it's like that, yeah. Macromedia doesn't exist anymore. Animating pixel art? I don't know if Flash is made for pixel art. Am I using my Cintiq? Yeah. We also have a Cintiq cam. I know. I'll try looking into how to set one up again. The problem I had with making us having a Cintiq cam before, other than the fact that the hinge broke on it, was that it would the drivers would start conflicting with the actual face cam. So I did find a different webcam in my basement, which maybe won't cause that problem. Since it's a different brand, so I can use two different drivers. I have to set that up. It's another thing someone can remind me on Discord. Is this mirror res? It is. Good ears. It might have a lot of catching up to do with cat pictures, what? Oh, this one's supposed to have skeleton actually has our mask going up. Kind of like, supposed to be like Scorpion and Sub-Zero and what's that game called? Mortal Shambats. So that's that arm. This arm. This arm. Are spreadsheets up for download? Are my spreadsheets? No. What do you mean? There isn't, you can't actually like mod the game or anything like that, so you can't load in your own spreadsheets. I'm assuming the way modding would work in Unity is that you would somehow tell it to load certain sheets from runtime? Or at runtime? Not really sure. Has anyone ever here made a moddable Unity game? Marshall Fisticuffs? Mortal Shambats? You guys remember those? Those are great games. Those are one of my favorite games. Our feet! Gotta go see you, Brian. Painted feet for days. Hey, Zambi, how's it going? Just in time to watch us make this skeleton ninja here. This is looking good. Thanks, Molten. Hopefully people enjoy the skeleton sprites, and if they don't, well, then I failed this game. Oh, these are not supposed to be these feet. Keep forgetting she already has her set toes for standing still. Hey, DJ Alex. What am I making? We are working on Skyhook, and we're making a Halloween update for it. It's a 2D platformer where you fight with grappling hooks. We're working on some spooky new sprites for the game. And this is the skeleton version of our ninja character, Inara. That goes there. And then this is looking up so you can see a little bit more of the skeleton. I didn't realize this frame was right down there. I could use that to color pick this whole time. You're a dev too? Cool. What are you working on these days? Hey, Tutus Master, how's it going? All right, so these frames you can see are exactly the same as the previous one, which is kind of it's like a price to pay when you copy pasta. Like, these should just use the same animation. When I first made the game, I was like, oh, they're totally gonna have different dodge animations, whether they're on the ground or in the air. Like, guess what? They never did. It's one of those cases where placeholder art becomes the actual art, you know? Snake Evolved, cool. Recreation of the old Snake game from Nokia phones, nice. That's a cool idea. What are you developing in? Find a programming course, so fixed on the point that I should be programming that I have no ideas for either of them. What kind of stuff do you have to program? Fusion Engine, nice. Ahoy, what's up, Elder Yag? Or is it Elder Yag? Alright, that the dodge. I don't know what either of those are for. This is melee. Her hand gets really big. Cutting in the forearm bones, so it looks like a skeleton. Pascal, but I'm already made some things in it, so simple and not object oriented, but I think I want to do all the things, but any idea would be appreciated. However you like. All right, Yag. It's almost done, cool. That's to the arm. So again, just making the arm skinnier in places. So it looks more skeleton-like. I'm actually doing this with a mouse. Plan to publish it on Google Play Store. Sweet, dude. Have you published a game on Google Play before? Make a simple racing game named Simple Racing. Creativity for the win. I know you're making a racing game, DJ Alex. How's it coming? This is cool because now the back arm can have the split bone. So it really looked like a skeleton. And the ghost. These are the body or the dead bodies. Oh, that shouldn't be see-through, I just realized, because you can, your body's on the other side. Some of these I made see-through, which is bad, because you shouldn't be able to actually see through them, because your body should be behind the arm, like this one right here. Same with all of these, actually. All right, so they're not completely see-through, because her body should be behind the arm, just occluded. What are we working on today, King of One World? We're continuing working on the Halloween updates for Skyhook. So today we're working on Skelinara, who is the skeleton version of our ninja character. Why are you not following me, Zeddy? Probably because you hate my guts. It's the only reason I can think of. That does remind me though, if you guys are watching the show and you're enjoying it, please consider hitting that follow button. And of course, if you really, really hate the show, then you could consider subscribing just to show me how much you actually do hate me. I like your guts. It's the face I don't like. Oh, you should have made that clear, dude. I would have got rid of my face a long time ago. Oh, I wish I knew, Zeddy. I wish I knew. And remember, if you have Amazon Prime, you now get one free sub every month if you sign up for it. If you add your Amazon account to your Twitch account, which gives you Twitch Prime. Okay, so are there any areas where the arm has a hole in it and it shouldn't? A lot of these animations. So it could have a little bit of a hole, but some of the hole, like you should still feel like there's a cape behind that armhole. It'll make it feel more real, like more grounded in the character. Cool, I think she's looking pretty good. Oh, a couple of incorrect holes. I know you love me. No need to hide it. Not in front of the kids, Eddie. Exclamation, new quasi face. There's no you in my name. And that one gets a pixel. And that one gets a pixel. All right, that's all of these. Double check these. Unity is streaming? What? The actual Unity company, you mean? It's pretty cool. They do like live tutorials and stuff from time to time. Alright, I think we're good. Let's try her on for size. Oh, her feet. Okay, we're good on everything but her feet in some of the animations. Can we do the Skylark Twitch game at the end? Of course. Boop a doop a doop a doop a doop. Skelinara. She's a skeleton. She's looking pretty cool. Looking pretty skeleton-like, if you guys can see her. There she is. It's cool, you know, you know how it has this like scale function for your game view. You can just like zoom in. Skelinara. Nah, take that, you mean shark. Go away, you're a mean shark. Okay, so her jump is good. Duck is broken. Melee is missing the feet. Swing animation missing the feet. Oops. Dodge animation is missing the feet. Or flash step is missing. No, it's just the swing is missing the feet. Okay, so swing and melee are missing feet. Otherwise, she's mostly there. What? What and a what? What? I'm happy you're back on Skyhook. Really, Zeddy? Why is that? Spawn is missing the feet. The death animation is missing the feet, and then she'll be done. So we just need to color in all of her feet. This is the only game I enjoy watching you work on. Wow. What are you trying to say about my new games? Never written any AI, but I'm quite interested. Was writing AI for the CP players a challenge? It was, yeah. Writing the Skyhook AI is probably one of the hardest things I ever did. And still not, you know, it still has its flaws and stuff, but I had to just accept it at a point and just get it, you know, get it out there. Yeah, it was definitely hard. But it's doable. Like I didn't do it for a long time because I thought I would just never be able to do it. And then once I finally did, you know, I had AI for a game. Convergent Hakuna isn't fun for you to watch? Gotcha. You do listen though? Oh, thanks, dude. Okay, so keep missing. So it said her duck animation. Oh, this is her duck animation? So I can just copy this. That hand is all mixed up because there's not enough colors back there. You need to put some colors for these feet. Okay. Other missing feet. I don't know what this frame is doing here. Don't need it. Those. Beep and a beep. So for these, I'm actually just painting in her shoe to cheat the feet, right? I'm not actually drawing the toes and stuff, but their frames are really only last for like a second or two. And so in order to save time, it's not worth polishing these too hard, I don't think. How's Gaik doing in the sales department? Not too well. It's doing just about how I expected it to. It's not a blockbuster game. Like I was saying earlier on stream, it's very difficult to sell local multiplayer games now, which is why I would advise anyone who might be working on one to not work on one, because it's not a good kind of genre that's working right now, especially not 2D platformers. Her feet. Alright, there goes that. Oh, now all her melee feet. Why did you guys let me give her toes? Add like an extra hour to her skin. But I guess it'll be worth it for the style. This goes here, that means this feet goes there. This feet goes there. Here we'll just get back to coloring it in. This feet, hopefully Inara's feet are the selling point in the Halloween update. We'll be like, Skyhook Halloween update now featuring more Inara feet. So multiplayer games aren't so multiplayer games. Local multiplayer game was this was that what I was saying, and not multiplayer games. Multiplayer games, you know, of course sell. However, depending on the game, local multiplayer games are a difficult sell. And I knew this. I didn't know this when I started the game. Obviously, I knew it as development progressed. But I had a choice to either give up and never finish the game, or just, you know, get it out there. And I'm much happier having a game out there, of course. But if you're thinking about starting a local multiplayer game, the thing about local games is that they seem really fun when you have people around and when you show them at conventions and stuff, because a lot of people there to play them. But couch co-op isn't really something that's working as a selling point right now. Is this the feet update? It is, Tasha Sean. How'd you know? Yeah, exactly what Toja said. Hey Drinkler, so adding multiplayer online, it's not really worth it for this game. I might have done it if the game had sold better, right? But being that it's a game that didn't sell that well, it's not really worth the time investment. The game is already released, so any added hype it would get from online, like there would be, it wouldn't really. There wouldn't be any hype for adding it online, right? There's no hype for the game as it exists. Adding it online will fall to empty ears or whatever the term is. Like there's no one listening, right? So like it's not like many people would care. The only people that would care that it has online are people who already have the game. It's not really a game that has visibility anymore since it's already been released. I guess that's what I'm trying to say. Visibility is the word, I think, I was trying to say. Yeah. The game doesn't have much visibility since it's already released, meaning that adding something like a big feature like online, which will probably say take me a few months or whatever, and X thousand dollars to make, there won't be anybody to even know that it's there. Feeding pearls to pigs? What? What are you talking about? If you didn't launch with online, maybe it would have drawn more attention, but at this point, it's not really worth it. Agreed. And, like, interestingly enough, like, that's what I thought too originally, but then when I saw other games, other local games that launched with online, it didn't make a difference. You know, people still didn't, like, the online community didn't grow. And I think the reason, at least my theory is the reason for that is because these games were designed for the couch, they were designed for fairly short play periods and fairly contained experiences that were fun when somebody was there. And when you don't feel that online, the game just isn't fun for many, many hours. At least in my opinion. But then again, you know, there are of course exceptions to the rule. I think games like Duck Game, people can seem to play for like tons of hours on end. Like I freaking love Duck Game, but I can't play it for as long as I guess some of the other people do. And even that, even Duck Game gets complaints where people are just like, oh, there's not enough people playing online. And it's one of the biggest like online communities for couch games. Skyhook 2, The Hookening. Apparently it's called Sky Noon. It's already been done for me. I don't even have to worry about it. What I am curious about exploring a little bit more is the game we made for Quasi Jam 7. I've been thinking about a lot. I've been trying to see if I could design something a little bit more solid based on that premise. If you guys were around for the last Game Jam, I made a game about ghosts and possessing things and killing people. It was an online multiplayer game where you possess things and try to kill the other players. I've been thinking about it a lot lately. I'm trying to figure out a solid kind of design premise for it. Because like I said before, I really want to try to release one more game this year. We only have 3 more months to do that. And that one more game is not going to be Convention Tycoon. Can I post a link for my version of Skelinar? Absolutely, Tanner Roboduck. It'd be pretty cool with the multiplayer because every time I think I'd speedrun as in if that would be a couch game, it'd be boring. But the multiplayer makes it more fun because you can play with friends online. True. Jessica Mack, thank you for the host. Oh my goodness. How's it going? You're just in time to watch us work on the pixel art Halloween update for our game Skyhook. Welcome everyone to Jessica Mack's channel. Oh, that's a cool idea, Tiny Roboduck. You made her a Grim Reaper. Oh, I wish I could have done that, but the problem is, you know, they only have one weapon in the game, which is a grappling hook and her sword. I could make her sword a scythe. But that's a really cool idea, dude. I love it. I love little skeleton skull, too. Awesome job. This looks like her face is just getting smushed. It's because the hood should come forward, I guess? Or it does come forward. But yeah, for everyone just tuning in from Jessica Mack's channel, my name is Quasi. This is Quasi TV. This is a channel where we work on games. And today we're working on the Halloween update for my game that's currently on Steam called Skyhook. It's a game where you fight with grappling hooks, and it's a 2D platformer. Why not replace the hook with a scythe on the chain? That's a really awesome idea. But can a scythe really work as a hook? See, she also has her melee. We could make this a scythe, but no one will ever really notice. If we make this a scythe, I don't know how that'll work as a hook. I mean, it kind of already is a scythe. Will we get an extra mission, Fight of Hordes of the Undead? I want to do something like that, yeah. What I'm probably going to do is make a new quest or two about fighting all these skeleton skins. So like, this is the grappling hook. I mean, we could technically be like, we could technically, let's see, let's copy this. We would notice. So what does the site look like again? Wait, I need to look up a site now. Scythe. Oh. Yeah, see, it's also a tough sell for the hook part. Because it can't be, it has to be this big. This is a problem, right? We're constrained to the size of the hook. The hook cannot be bigger than this. So it can only be like a mini scythe, which now looks stupid. But maybe something like on that size. Have you seen Brawlhalla? Of course, yeah, I love Brawlhalla. Played the crap out of it when it first came out. I also got the chance to meet the devs at TwitchCon. Really, really great dudes. Or some of the devs. There's a whole bunch of them. So, it doesn't really look like a scythe. It looks just like a thingamathing. I was wondering if you knew why bits don't work on everyone's streams. Bits are currently only for partnered streamers, I believe. So only streamers that have sub buttons have bits. And then you also get an option whether you want it or not. So even some partner streamers don't have bits on because they haven't turned it on. You have to turn it on yourself as a streamer. It's not automatically on. But it's only for partner streamers. I would love to have a star system. 1 star unlocks, for example, is a Viking. 2 star for Jade. That would be out of scope, Haystein, right? Because we don't really have a star system anywhere else in the game. We'll probably just have different quests to unlock the different skeleton skins. But yeah, Titan, freaking great idea with the whole scythe, dude. Let's see what it looks like in game. We're gonna copy the old one so we don't lose it. Put it over here. And so the hook has two states. It has regular and open. So like, how the hell do we do that with a scythe? Zeddy, is your idea for the scythe hook? Oh, well, I mean, I took the idea from Titan's pixel art, but yeah, it was both your ideas. You're right. You're right. You're right, yo. But Titan actually did it in his pixel art. I just don't know if this is going to actually work in the game, but only one way to find out. Abbreviation, for example, is EG. I think so. I don't really understand why. I assume because science. Have you got stream delay? Yeah, there should be a stream delay. Is that what you mean? Or you're saying is a really high stream delay. So this is when it's being pulled out. It's Latin, gotcha. Oh, we'll just give it a shot. See what she looks like. Still missing some feet in a few frames, I think. Mostly just two places. Let's just finish that up before we forget. Wall sliding and dying, which we've already done the dying ones. Wall sliding. Hook could be a skeleton hand. That'd be cool. Stands for ID for id est, which means that is. Gotcha. We need to fix the hoods here because she doesn't have hair. Skellinar doesn't have hair. Hood. And gotta forget the bony fingers, or can't forget the bony fingers. I think this head's a little bit too big. Let's bring it down a pixel. So you're somewhere in between dead, not dead. Dude, you've been going super hard. You need to, you need like 6 days off, I think. You need like a full 6 days off to recover. All right, and let's put these in. So these are all actually just rotated versions of this. So we're gonna put in a new layer. Just goes that. And then this one is just a rotated version of this one. Aha, hex. Merge that down. Okay, so we got feet there, feet there. Any feet missing? We got all the feet, I think. You guys see all the feet? Got all the feet. Feet there, feet there, feet there. Okay, I think she might actually be mostly done. Yeah, save. Did I save? A friend of mine is a YouTuber. He makes Minecraft animations and his birthday is tomorrow because of his occasion. Can I link his YouTube channel? No. I'm not sure why you think that should mean you could link his YouTube channel. I just left for 12 hours almost. I have some adulting to do and then back to it. Should have it on full release tonight or in late hours of the morning. Cool, dude. Well, take it easy. Please don't kill yourself. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. Trying to get as much work done as possible before his child arrives and the sleepless nights kick in. Undead? That's true, I guess they are all undead. There we go. So here's what the scythe hook looks like. It's actually pretty badass. Holy crap. We can make it even a little bit better, but that's kind of cool. I don't know if you, can you guys see it? Let me go into the second box. Look at this scythe hook. It's pretty sweet. Oh man. So, since you guys are amazing, what should the other zombie character's hooks be? That looks so cool. Look at that, when it sticks in, it's a scythe. Yes, I'm making those sound effects for the game. That looks so freaking cool. Holy crap, good idea. Oh, and when it, look, when it actually hooks, when it hooks like this, oh, when it looks like that, ugh, when it looks like, it's, oh, look at that, it's actually hooked onto the platform, because it's a scythe, ah, so good. When you zoom in, you can move on the screen by pressing, moving the scroll button, I think. Scroll button? I don't think so. What's the scroll button? Uh-oh. That's the game. Oh, you mean the mouse wheel? No, it doesn't do anything. It's weird. I wonder why they... There probably is some control. You're definitely right. A ship anchor is a good one, Dr. Banks. Mr. Dr. Banks. Zombie could use a severed hand hook. Ooh. Anchor's a good one. I guess Finn's could be an anchor. Or Grimlock. Finn and Grimlock could both have anchors. He could throw his hand. Maybe Runa would throw her hand. Because she's going to be... Maybe she's more of a zombie. Let's try... where is that? Not here. Which is Skelefin. This is Skelefin. Never actually gave him a hand. Never actually did his body yet, so. You have it attached by ligaments? Dead fish for the shark. That's... Oh, a fish skull is a good one, too. Oh, man. Let's draw some of these and see how they went look. We can't change the grapple string, unfortunately. That's all just like a line. It's a single line. But a dead fish is hilarious. Yeah, the grapple hook line, unfortunately, has to be one thing because of the way it's created in game. I don't have too much control over it, but... Oh, shoot. What does a dead... What does a fish skeleton look like again? Fish skeleton. Man, scroll wheel actually doesn't work in runtime. Yeah, I guess it only works in the thing view. So something like that as a grappling hook? A circle for the eye? We can't really do a circle, we can do a square. It should look angry, so I'm gonna make it like that. That would be hilarious. Time to rework the grapple rope to allow for custom skins. Yeah, that is perfectly in scope. You're absolutely right. Fishy needs a tail. The tail's, well, it's going to have to be attached to this grapple hook thing. So we won't actually have room for a tail. And this is probably already too long. Oh crap, is an R missing pixels? I guess we fix that. It looks so dumb. Who knows? Maybe that'll be funny. Actually, I guess we could just try it out on Finn. So it's meant for this character. We can make it like open its mouth when it's coming out. It might not work. The anchor is a good one too. We could give Jade an anchor. Oh, we could give Jade the cat, the fish, if the fish works. Hey, Caraway, welcome back. Thin skeleton skin. So which character would have a fish grappling hook? Would it be the shark or would it be the cat? What? It didn't update. It's bullshit. Oh, that's the hook when it's out. I forgot to update the hook when it's in. So that's like the constraints of what the hook can look like, the, what the size of the hook can be. Because they're so damn tiny. Hmm. We'll see what it looks like when we shoot it. It's kind of funny. Actually, I like it. It's silly. It's not as cool as the Grim Reaper thing, but it's silly enough. And maybe we could stick a tail in there. How would we? Just make the edge of it a tail. Can we make this thing actually a tail? So the tail is like a metal part. It's kind of funny, but should a skeleton fish be shooting at a tiny skeleton fish? A little weird? A little tiny bit weird? That a fish shoots out a little tiny fish? What did you miss? Well, we worked on Scoops. We finished Skeleton Inara. This is our first completed Halloween skin. Here she is with her Grim Reaper scythe. It's his little brother. How about a shark fin? It'll just look like a Reaper thing. It might work on Skeleton Jade. The cat shoots a fish? Should be a dagger? That's just a knife. We'll just make it look like a triangle. What's up, Wheeze? And then, oh yeah, the other idea was an anchor, which is really cool. That face. The face of a Viking. Cat shoots a yarn ball? Yarn balls don't have skeletons. What does an anchor look like again? Anchor. So waiting for Benara. You're going to be waiting the rest of your life, Asimbi. The rest of your life. Oh, anchors are way more complicated than I thought. Something like that. A lopsided anchor. Does someone already have an anchor hook, actually? I think. Not 100% sure. That just looks like a grappling hook now. Damn it! Anchors look like grappling hooks. It's because it needs to curve in, but I don't have all the pixels. Use a pen for your drawing. I use a pen, yeah. Ball of intestine that looks like a ball of yarn. Oh my god. Okay, this anchor looks like a shovel. Let's try this. Boop. Two, two. One, 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 one. But really, I feel like you have to really know it's an anchor to see it. Oh, that's a good one. Hold on. A fish hook. Like a fishing hook? That's a good idea. Those just look like regular hooks though, right? Does that kind of look like an anchor? Think. Which one of these look like an anchor to you guys? Second one looks good as an anchor. So this is 1, 2, 3. You see it big? Can make it rusty looking. We hardly have enough pixels to make it regular looking. Bottom right, this one. Two. Thanks, guys. What about the eye that splats out on contact, Titan Roboduck? Just use a brownish color, yeah. We'll mess with the color afterwards. Wait, what if this one had the triangle? No. What about a tri-tooth thingy? You mean a grappling hook? That's a grappling hook. A trident, yeah, that's what he already has. So Finn normally has a trident. See, this one is so small now. It needs to be like this size. Alright, well, we'll mess with this one more later. An entire boat, I like it. Gotta go see a diver, thanks for hanging out, dude. We might just leave the trident. It's his thing. Like, maybe like a bony trident or something. That might be cool. Let's move the fish here. Put the trident back. Maybe we'll just do like a bone trident. Hello? Program? Are you working? There you are. So if we do gold, gold, and a white, and a dark. Maybe just use a bit darker color. Feels ignored. What'd you say, Haystein? Did you fix that bug I found a long time ago, flying in the air on the select menu? Not sure what you mean. Don't really remember the bug. Could try to make it look like it's made of bones. Don't think that'll really come across though. You want to, of course, make sure this is a skeleton hand. And we're going to split it. Which is what really gives it that spooky feeling. What's up, Penguin? Elephant. Yeah, the trident just looks cooler. The bone trident looks way cooler. Let's see what we have here. Check it out. I just like it better. All white trident, right? Just fits with Finn. It's not loading for me this time. It just loaded my Google Drive. It didn't actually load the image. You want to try uploading it to like Imgur or something? Yeah, you know what that trident needs? That'll make it just perfect. Is it should look like these So these were fine. It should look like the tips are separate. But a bug is a bug, okay. Let me just tell it in words. Sure. I mean, the image is not just not loading. Oh, it's a video. The video is not loading for me either. I'm not sure what's going on. But you guys can see the video. I don't know why it's not loading for me. Let me try a different browser. Hold on. And King of One World, thanks for the cheers, dude. Let's try Internet Explorer. Okay, it loaded there. So what's the bug? Oh! What happened? The person canceled, right? Yeah. That's a good question. Let's find out. That's a really good question. Let me get my other controller out. I don't remember. I remember you showing us that before. I don't remember if we fixed it or not. So I will join as player one on this controller. And I will join as player two on this controller. Let's go up here. Let's hang on top. You come up here. I.e., I know Slark. All right. So the trick is I hook onto them and he cancels. There we go. Okay, so it's not fixed. So we could probably just fix that right now. Thanks, Haystein. Thanks for remembering that. So hook and cancel. So I believe what happens here is our locator gets destroyed, and so we create a new one. We say if our locator is null, then create a new object. I think this is what's causing it. It's a nice bug. I think it's this. But it also happens here. That's on cancel. Locator's new game object, and then locator.position equals from. This is when we're spawning, so I don't care about that. Locator.parent equals null, return to owner. How does the hook just stay there? I wonder what keeps the hook from saying that. So we have a method called destroy player, and it destroys the player and all this stuff. We also have a method called free all hooks in me. I'm assuming this is still happening. Okay, so maybe we just need to call free all hooks in me and that'll fix the bug. So if we call current player dot free, it's not a public thing. Free all hooks in me, make it public. What this does is just check to see if there's any hooks inside of the player. It's like a hack basically. And it goes through any hooks inside of the player and then just disconnects them. So we should be calling that when we destroy the player. Just leave it funny to look at and play around with. Yeah, we'll give it a shot. Let's see, fix it in a few minutes. So one player there. Let's go in your room. All right, and hook, there we go, fixed. Hook and cancel, and the hook goes back. So the best way to see it clearly is we'll go to the top. Go up here. So we'll reproduce it the same way. Put this character up here. All right. Hook and, oh, oops, I did it too soon. All right. Hook and cancel. There we go. Problem solved, no errors. And the hook goes back, and this guy is good to keep hooking another day. Rip the funny glitch. Thanks for catching that, dude. And I really appreciate you remembering that after all this time, because I know you had showed that to me a while back. So thanks so much for keeping that in mind and showing it to me again. Okay. And I think there was, so we finished Skellinara. There was one, what was it, one more thing? We added the eyes. Oh, there's a couple of things. So I came up with a few achievement ideas yesterday I wanted to put in really quickly. So I made a new achievement for unlocking all the dark skins. So I now have a method to check if you have all the skins of a certain type. So yeah, it was 4 or 5 months ago. I know, thanks for remembering. Until Nick, hello, how's it going, dude? So I made new achievements for whether or not you've unlocked every dark skin, every pink skin, every skeleton skin, etc. So that I made last night. What I want to add is an achievement if you unlock all the trophies. So in the game, every time you finish a battle, the game assigns every... Did anybody else see that? Did you guys see that? DLC Weird Clouds? What the F was that? Undo the fix? Anyways, I was saying, in the game you get different trophies. Ginger Chicken with the Scaredy Cat. For anyone who doesn't know, I actually made the Scaredy Cat emote. So you get all these trophies in the game as you play more and more. And each trophy is assigned to different players every time. Bug equals bug times two. So I never thought to make an achievement where you unlock all the trophies. Slark Knight with the one. Oh my god. So let's make a trophy thing. So trophy manager. So we have trophy info, all the trophy info, and awarded trophies. We do this. This is where we create all the trophies in the game. They're all just hard-coded. I don't have a text file or anything. I just write them in code since I make the game by myself. And then on level was loaded. We do something. Awarded trophies equals new dictionary type. If can have trophy. Okay. And all right, so where do we actually deal with awarded trophies? Awarded trophies dot add here. What is this? Where do we actually save what trophies we've unlocked? And if about the stream, Lazy Norm, how's it going? I think that pumpkin should look like this. What is that? I might have an early buyer glitch. Early buyer glitch? What does that mean? So awarded trophies, I go null, and trophies, award trophies that count. For each trophy, add by weight. So let's go to the ship log maybe. We basically want to see log controller. We want to know all the trophies we've unlocked. We have a log page called trophy page. I actually don't know how this is made. Log tab controller. There we go. Let's go see if we could find the object in the scene. It's only for people that had the game before achievements. I think I might know the glitch you're talking about, but let me see what it is. Is it related to the quest trophies? Ship log. That's the log. So the actual log is here. There's the book. So trophy log panel is the thing. And that's all these trophy logs. And they are just stat rows. Oh, here we go. Trophy view. Trophy view is what we're looking for. Skyhook stopped working? What happened? I'm using 5.5? No way, DJ Alex. I'm using the stable one, 5.4.1. You don't want to use betas when you're publishing a game, right? So this game's on Steam, so I don't want to use a beta because it might cause issues. What do you mean Skyhook stopped working, Haystein? Okay, so here's our trophy view. Create trophies. We go through all the trophies. In trophy info. And we check to see if it's unlocked here. So we're going to write a method here. We're going to put it in this class just so I can get a reference to this stuff. We're going to move it later. So public void unlocked or has unlocked all trophies. What that's going to do is this is a list of trophy types. Okay. So we have this. And we have this. So these are all of our trophies. This is a dictionary, I believe. So we're going to go through all of our trophies. Yep, it's a dictionary. I forgot to unlock the Flying Dutchman. I don't remember. You have to beat all the quests or something. But you're saying the achievement for that's not getting unlocked? So we're gonna check basically. So int total equals zero. And we're gonna see if data manager.minstance.unlocked trophies.contains our trophy.value. Right, which I believe is a, it's just a trophy. So a trophy.key. This is a list of trophy types. So we're basically going to iterate over all of our possible trophies and check to see. Sean is crazy. What's up, dude? Check to see if it's been unlocked. And if it has, we're going to say total plus. Actually, no, we don't have to do that. We can just say if it hasn't been unlocked, then return false. That's way simpler. Otherwise, return true. So check to see if there are any trophies that have not been unlocked. If so, return false. Going to bed. See you, Tiny Robo Duck. Thanks for the awesome scythe help, dude. Jade card worth 50 cents? Are you serious? So yeah, we're going to iterate over all of our unlocked trophies, or all of our trophies, and check to see if they've been unlocked. If a single one of them hasn't been unlocked, then we have not unlocked all trophies. And so the place we're going to actually use this method is in evaluate achievements. Well, actually, no, not here. We're going to use it, I guess in the trophy manager. See you, Italian. All right, and so when we award a trophy, or when we've done awarding trophies, so this can be initialize trophies. When is a trophy manager used? Trophy panel, set trophies, game over panel. So here, get my trophies. So here's where we get all the trophies. We'll do the check for trophy achievement. Can you log the trophies with your F1 thingy so you can check? I can't, but we'll have to add that in, yeah, to make sure the achievement works. So we're gonna say trophy manager.minstance.has all unlocked trophies. So if we have our trophy manager and you've unlocked all our trophies, then data manager unlock achievement. We have to make an achievement for this. So we're gonna call this all versus trophies. So if we've unlocked all of our trophies, then we're gonna unlock that achievement. And we're gonna check this at the end of each match, basically, because that's when you unlock new trophies. Now, how do we actually... Oh man, I used to listen to this song on loop so much. So if unlock trophies is where we actually add them. Unlock trophy. So we'll make another method and we'll call this the trophy manager. Public void unlock all trophies. Now it'll do the same thing. It'll iterate over our trophy dictionary. And for each one of those trophies, it'll just unlock them. Right, so iterate over all our trophies and say, this is unlocked, that's unlocked, that's unlocked, that's unlocked. And so on unlock everything, here we're gonna call trophy manager minstance.unlockAllTrophies. I'm gonna finish adulting stuff, then back to work on Paper Aces. Have a great night. See ya, Devin. Good luck, dude. Make sure you get some rest. Get some food in ya. Take some vitamins. And please don't die. Okay, so... Ship log. We have no trophies because we have a brand new... Whoa! We go to ship log. Look at the... It says toggle A, done escape. Toggle is not A. Oh, it's thinking WASDA probably. That's funny. I'll try to fix that. AD is toggle. Because left and right is toggle here. Oh, crap. That's weird. So I hit control F1. Should unlock everything. Now we have all the trophies unlocked. As you can see, they're not grayed out anymore. So the actual... Oh, look. That one trophy doesn't even show. There's not enough space at the bottom. What's up with that? Trophy panel. So these... I don't know what sets the height for these. They're inside of like some sort of a content scrolling thing or no? It's just a mask. I think it's just this page height. So what decides the height here? Panel height is 2.4. Panel final height is 30.4. I think that's dynamic. Was this game on Steam Greenlight Penguin? It was, yeah. Graphics do I have? I have the 1070. You can see it in the specs down below in the channel description. So yeah, now we have to actually add the achievement on Steam before we can actually test whether or not that achievement unlocks. But let's put a debug here in our trophy manager for this method so we can actually see if it works. So we're gonna do a quick match and we should get all our trophies are unlocked. Cheater! Sorry, Noble. quick match. Come on, bots. Bring it on. Bring it on. Oh, it should have been Skellinar. Probably double testing if we do that. Skellinara, she's a Nara, and she's a skeleton. Excuse me, bots, you're just gonna stand there? Let me. Oh, wrecked! Okay, and has unlocked all trophies, is returning true. So there you go, we got the achievement. Except the achievement doesn't exist, so Steam throws an error. Let's try a different stage so I can see what the skeleton R looks like on a regular stage. So here she is, our favorite skeleton character, with her scythe hook. Oh, wrecked again by Jaguar Jade. Her flag is, I think it needs to be the light flag. Because the main brown color is a little bit too dark for them. Looks a little purple too. We need to tweak the brown. Oh, I win. Take out my scythe and go running. Yeah, so one more thing is we can check that. So we can go to Violet. Where we use it. Oop, that's my alarm, which means it's almost time to go. So we do it here. I kind of hack it so that they get special flags for different skin colors. So we're going to say if dark or skin type equals skelly. And use the like flag. Oh. Ryan Clark, thank you for the host! How is it going, dude? Were you streaming today? Don't think it's Friday. It's actually the complete opposite of Friday. Alright, let's try Skellafin. Actually, no, but we don't do subscriber Steam keys anymore for the game. But the game is on Steam if anybody wants to pick it up. In fact, Moobot just dropped the command for it. Alright, so interesting about Skellafin is that he blends in really well with the snow environment. Oh, when you have double jump, you have a little cloud under your feet. And if you're a brown character, it looks like you have a little cloud of poop. A little poop cloud. A little mud cloud. Regular Finn doesn't stand a chance. Yeah, that looks a lot better with the white flag. Sad, sorry. Sorry.
Oh. Yeah.
And Jogard, thank you for the host. Oh my goodness. What's up, dude? Oh, double kill. We really need to do Skeleton's body. Just cause he's out of keys. I'm all out of keys. Steam took them all away from me. They're like, you know what? Oh, wrecked. And his dead body's invisible. I think if people hit the 1 year sub mark, they should get a key. It's not a bad idea. How's it going, Jovegard? How's your stream, dude? Welcome everybody from Jovegard's channel. This is Quasi TV. We are currently working on the Halloween update to our 2D platformer called Skyhook. We also develop a game here called Convention Tycoon, which is a game where you create and manage your own video game convention. Skyhook is back. Yeah, we're making a little Halloween update for it. So we have some skeleton skins for the characters. We've been working on some skeleton skins for the characters and a new main menu for Halloween. And so basically the game will dynamically shift between different holiday stuff depending on the season. So we're gonna add all of Halloween today. We might add some winter stuff in November. There'll be like snow and stuff everywhere. One year ago, $6, decent price for Skyhook. Skyhook's only $5 if you wanna get it at a cheaper price. When will the update come out, Lazy Norm? Well, we finished Skellinara. Skella Jade will probably take a few hours too. She's a little bit harder. Skella Runa will be a little bit, will be just as easy as Skella Nara, probably like an hour or two. And then Skella Fan will probably take another hour. So I would say 6 more hours to make the skins. And then probably 6 more hours to do the quests for those skins. So I think 2 more days probably on the update. And so my goal is to have it on Steam by Friday. So we can get it done by Wednesday and then test it Wednesday, Thursday, and then have it up on Steam by Friday. For anyone who has the game, you can actually get access to the private beta on Steam. So private beta, if you have the game, branch password is fish out of water. So if you put fish out of water into your Steam beta tab, you actually get access to a private beta where I'll be uploading whatever we work on. I'll be uploading that to Steam so you guys can test it out for us. Should change your tag back to hashtag programming. Oh yeah, good idea, Penguin. I forgot about that. We've been programming for a little while now. We jump all between pixel art and stuff, so I don't want to make anybody upset. But actually, guys, it is that time of day. It is that time of day where we must head out into Twitchosphere and find some jerk out there streaming whom we can raid and fill with the pixel art loves. So let's see what's going on out here on hashtag gamedev. Could you show me? Can I show you? Press the. I can't turn on Steam because it screws up the bandwidth for my stream. But you just go to a game, right click properties, and then you'll see a little tab for betas. You can just click on that and ask your password. And hello, Presti. How are you? No, cool. It's gonna be not today. I have to actually get running. I have a thing I have to get to. But hopefully Wednesday. You guys need to remind me on Wednesday. I've been skipping Cooldown Sketches for a while now. Stream almost over. I should not leave yet. Time to cry, people. Time to leave. Yeah, and a little bit early today. But maybe we'll go a little bit longer on Wednesday if we can. And that being said, I am slowly progressing us back to 5 days a week. We're getting there. We're really close. I'm getting us really close to transitioning back to streaming 5 days a week again. So I'm excited about that. And hopefully some of you jerks will stick around and watch the show more often. And if you don't want to watch it, you should just hit the subscribe button just to prove it. Just to prove it. Oh, man. Let's go drop some love on someone who very recently got their sub button. Let's go drop some love over here. So guys, it's time for me to go. If you enjoyed the show, please, please, please hit that follow button. If you really, really hate the show, again, please subscribe. We're gonna get going. We're gonna be back on Wednesday with more Halloween pixel art updates for Skyhook, and then back to some 3D games after that. I'll see you guys then. But in the meantime, let's get ready for a raid. Our raid message is gonna be Spoopy Raid. And we're gonna be raiding the very awesome twitch.tv/Arconics, who just very recently got their sub button. So let's show them some love and congratulate them. If you guys don't know how to raid works, we're all gonna head into that channel and we're gonna drop the message Spoopy Raid all at one time. So as soon as you see me say something in chat, let's all fill the chat with some Spoopy Raids. And Boots and Pants works just as fine too. Until then, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye. I mean, not tomorrow. Wednesday. Bye.